joke. Like the inspectors always work. They help treat the puppy, beat the puppy. Then they come to poke. Doggy look a ball. Doggy look a ball. After election, all the bone done. So come and touch it. Don't look so shocked. Don't just watch it. Doggy suck.
Just about 11 minutes after the hour of 4 o'clock in TNT. Welcome, welcome one and all to the Future of Talk. I am in the building for now. Heavy Duty is on his way. All right? And you know how we do in the first hour. I want to say much love and respect going out to everyone that is now joining me on the various social media platforms. That is my friends out there on Facebook. Good afternoon to you at Street 919 FM on Facebook. To my peoples out there on Instagram as well. And of course to all my YouTubers, good afternoon, good afternoon. To even to those that is cussing us daily on those platforms, much love and respect to you, you know. And you know what we do in this hour? This is the Future of Talk with Heavy Duty and TC. So this is the hour we allow you to call in and get it off your chest. We know what takes place here, so sometimes you're calling various programs and you're not getting in. They just choose not to answer your call, all right? So we give you the opportunity here between the hours of 4 o'clock and 5 o'clock to call and, you know, vent, get it off your chest, say what you have to, you know, even though you are just calling to say hi as well, or maybe a birthday greetings. You know, this is your opportunity to call. You could also drop us a voice note at 342-0081. 342-0081. You could drop us a voice note there. We will make sure and play your voice notes. All right, you could WhatsApp call at that number as well. And the 466-539 number, you can call us on that number as well. All right, so the phone lines are open. This is the people's platform where you are in charge of this program from 4 to 7, all right? So let me start by playing this voice note here, right? And I await your call and your voice notes as well, all right?
Good day, everyone, TC. I want to talk about the young girl who got buried in Valentine and died there, the 18-year-old. It seemed to me that the residents in the area made various reports to the TTPS and the Social Welfare Ministry, and they didn't act. But yesterday I see it on the news, Donna Cox and the TTPS said they never received any such reports. Well, I want to disagree with the TTPS and Donna Cox. I know how all it is operate. All it is get report and throw it by the wayside, right? The people report incidents happening there, and all they never acted on it, and it's all they... that caused that little 18-year-old girl to be murdered there, right? So they take blame Donna Cox and the TTPS. It's all their fault that they never acted. What do all the people they go and do again? Eh? They report plenty times and all they never acted. But all they blaming the people and saying they didn't report nothing. Donna Cox, get her life, yeah? You're in the wrong ministry. Have a good day for that.
Thanks so much. Thanks so much for your... voice note there, and you can call me up. You know the numbers to call, 342-0081, 342-0081, and 466-5391. Yeah, there's a lot of conflicting reports where the reports is concerned. Some of the residents are saying they did try to make reports, or they did make reports, and some are saying that it wasn't their business, they didn't say anything. And as well as, well, I heard Ms. Cox coming out and saying, well, kind of throwing blame at the residents, you know, for the crucial things that was happening in that house in Valcine. What I don't understand is this. right? There was a lot of young adults in that house. When they were, when the police went there, right? There was a lot of young adults, right? And all they have this wicked old man doing all these things as young adults. I know this is years and years of punishment that has them like that, eh? But so nobody in the, on that team there of children or nephews or whoever it is couldn't break that barrier, boy. Nobody couldn't stand and say, see this, I'm not taking this no more. Because I saw the police arresting the alleged perpetrator last night. Right? And I know, young boy, that's not no spring chicken. When I looked at it, this is a big old man. You understand? Nobody couldn't overpower him. Nobody couldn't. He's going down in age. He's not 110% anymore. I mean, come on. I just find somebody in that household could have retaliated or, you know, done something to alert the authorities, you know, on their own. And I think it's one of the young men in the house who alerted the authorities after so long. And for this child to die since 2017 and buried in a shallow grave and stayed there until now, you know, 2017, and that is about 7 years, right? In 2024, it's 6 years and something, you know, which is pretty, 6 years and something, our entire household stayed silent to whatever took place with this young lady, you know, and the entire family has some kind of shady things happening around them. I really don't understand it. I really don't understand it, but some things that is taking place in Trinidad, as my good friend would say, you know, gruesome acts to kind of throw us off of our seats. Gruesome acts that will be taking place, you know, that we wouldn't understand, because in the last 2 years, I should say, the kind of gruesome acts we have been seeing, I mean, it have always been showing up its ugly head every now and then. Every now and then you would see gruesome acts showing its head now and then, but it's showing its head more blatant now, you know, after the killing of all those children in that house in the back of Arima there, you know, and then just when in the hills of Love until there, a mother had to be scraping a child brain off the ground and rushing him to hospital, died as well, you know. And then we have been hearing about shooting of children left, right, and center in Monrepo, in here and there, you know. And then it's just kind of distasteful now. It reached a point where it's not funny anymore. You know? I don't know how you think about it, but if these are the kind of things, you used to see these kind of things on international news, where the CIA or the FBI boss are doing is a set of children in a house suffering. You used to see that on international news, you know? And you would say to yourself, nah, them thing are taking place in Trinidad. Well, I guess it's here. So I wait your phone call. You know the numbers, 3420081 and 4665391. I don't know if we are getting WhatsApp today, because I know yesterday we were getting some problems with the WhatsApp. So you can call me and make a contribution. As I said, this is event in hour, this is your hour. All right? So you can call me. I'll give you some bone until you call. You understand?
Just watch it, doggy sock.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, TC.
Good afternoon.
I just locked down and I really appreciate this program. I'll always be, you know, and well, you know how I love this program now. You and Evie, and I wish you all the best for the evening and all the best for the callers that call in, coming in for this evening.
Thanks so much,
and, man. Thanks again.
Yeah, man. Bless your love. Yeah, man. Yeah? I like when you call and you let me know that you're out there and you're listening. So, you know, let me know that you're out there in full force. I'm seeing a police-involved shooting here, you know. And as usual, they're saying that that man don't be nothing, you know. So, I don't know. Let me play this voice note here as well. You can send your voice note. I'm playing your voice note as well. All right?
TC, Bitcoin here. I want to agree with you that the children could have acted up. But when this man abusing them from a young age and have a mental, you know, captivity over them, that he controlling them, they wouldn't know how this act up, you know, TC.
Yeah, for
because
real.
Because he subdued them.
For real.
That is years and years of abuse.
Mm-hmm.
So these children would have been subdued by attacks from this man. And that is how he controlling them. So that's why they didn't see it fit to take advantage and doing something. That is just my call, eh? Have
yeah.
a good day.
I understand what you're saying. Hi, good afternoon. Welcome.
Hey, this is my call.
Good afternoon, TC.
Stop listening to me on the radio.
I load on the radio. I might be blasting all the out too. The neighbors, I'm like the dog now, boy.
Yeah, for real.
I want to send condolences to the original nuts man by Jumbo, boy.
Yes, boy, yes. I heard Jumbo pass away to his family and everybody. Much love and
respect to Jumbo. And all his supporters who support Jumbo for all the years.
Yeah, man.
But by right, you see, Jumbo name supposed to be an nuts pack, you know?
Yeah, boy, yes, boy. I say the same thing.
Yeah.
Jumbo supposed to be starting some nuts pack somewhere.
I remember I saw some 20-ton cricketers in the Oval, they were fighting. Jumbo not going and said Sunshine starts coming and back. And Jumbo name supposed to be somewhere.
In one of them stands yeah, in the stadium, it's supposed to be the Jumbo standby.
Yeah, in the Oval or something, they were fighting them for the Oval in the 2020 cricket were going there.
Yeah, you know, the conglomerates want to sell the packs. So, you know.
Must say good afternoon to Tabaki. It's a new lockdown listener here this afternoon. Tabaki brought out the boots and come out now, man. No time to toot. You like to hear, come and make your contribution. I know the battle starts. This year never lockdown listening. Love and respect.
All right, man. Thanks. Heavy.
Good afternoon, Trinidad and Tobago. Good afternoon to you, TC. Good afternoon to everyone locked on. Yes, we are in the building. I just want to make mention right? That you have a caller?
No,
I just want to make mention of the work. Remember last week, Friday, I came here and I mentioned to you that I'm not seeing the opposition, the UNC work, right? I want to say I see it now.
I see it now.
Yeah,
that's something.
But all over the marginal constituencies, every day they're walking in up in St. Joseph and all these other marginal constituencies.
Yeah,
probably are not how we in Port of Spain side, probably, because we're not young here yet, but they're working on it.
All right.
Okay. Right?
Nice to see that. You could come now and say something else, but I still not seeing, but maybe...
No, probably how they throw me in about four different chat groups.
I did this so you could see what's going on.
I must say, yeah.
Doing more work
and they was inviting me too, to come and see too, so I must say, you know, they're really on the... And they actually, what do you call it? This word I'm looking for. They're interviewing candidates for the next election already too.
Okay.
For the general election, yes. You understand? So, down the ground. So, what are we doing this evening? What are you talking about in the event and what is it?
Well, because now started to come in.
Okay.
Hi, good afternoon. Welcome.
Good day, gentlemen. Thank God for the show on the station. Bring back a little balance now. Let's pull back that seal ship now, boy. The depression, you know, during the day and all. All in, no. Hurry over KFC, keep it up, keep up the boycott. Let all them voices be heard. Let the people know now when they want to raise price or they want to make statements. Let them know it's about cost to that. Let them know that we ain't taking no more oppression from all over them kind of thing. VMTC.
Yeah, man, we're here and here.
How will you find it shaping up? How will you find your place feeling post-carnival?
Post-carnival?
How you feeling? Whatever little energy carnival have, you have any of that feeling?
But
carnival was mean energy for you. I find carnival was an energy this year. Because we have too much of things. All this every week is something, you know. It's Dog Island. Now we have Valentine House. And now we have Spy Kids Tree.
Kola?
What we gonna do, boy?
I told somebody that the other day. As a matter of fact, I did a video on TikTok about that. I said it's like it's never ending. Right? Every week is something. We don't forget about the ship over Trinidad Tobago with the oil. No?
Oh, this is what I'm saying.
You understand?
We didn't get a chance to properly ventilate one issue. Yeah. And an next one on top of you.
On top of it. Trampling things. It's nothing like it. And never end the nightmare. Right? And like it didn't have no hero to save the day. Because like every week is something.
Well, you say the rules to save the day, but we need, people, we need some more information. But how, up to now, we don't know who, where the boat crew is and where the tugboat crew is.
Nope.
For the oil.
And right? Where the boat was coming from and where it was going to.
Where was going?
Well, we know it was coming from Venezuela, but we don't know where it was going. The same thing is Guyana.
And Guyana, up until them, never was never coming by them.
Nope.
Right? Mm-hmm. So right now we don't know. A boat is crashing we waters, pollute we waters, and we live in that just so.
Right? And on top of that, what sidetracked that whole thing is the cookie now that they say they find with the boat. And then they come and they say no. Right? And what people get distracted with around that same time they come and say how the salary of the ministers and the prime minister and the president, everybody must go and raise. And that is distraction. And then they come now after that, and they start to talk about something else.
What? Well, I'm looking for information for you today.
Why?
Friends and Fishermen of the Sea file a Freedom of Information Act request. Do you know that in 2016, 17, said Churchin did not receive a dollar from the state.
You sent us that video yesterday, not so?
I believe so.
But we played
that video months ago.
We played that video about three times.
And still
people said
yeah, that Churchin was losing money.
When on that video you sent us, the Prime Minister stood in that video and showed us that we wasn't losing money.
So what we closed it down for?
Okay.
As they said, right, a man was trying to save his friend from being indicted. Will be investigated with criminal charges for fake oil.
And so, that is the only logical explanation we could think of, because no other reason suggesting that.
Because the company wasn't losing money. Actually, the company was in profit.
We're making money.
And you know what's sad thing about it? They hire a company, right, to investigate Petrochem to find out whether or not it was feasible or if they close it down. And they spend millions of dollars to pay that company. And the company tell them, no, the company don't need to close down.
They need to restructure.
And they still close down the company.
Why? I don't know. I tell a man the other day on the radio, he said he wasn't getting water and move on. What to them, TC? Change the MP. Change the MP. See, change it up and see now. What's the worst that could happen? You're going to have a worse off MP than you have now? Never. That's the worst that could happen. That the person who come in, just a little better than the man who leave it. That's the worst. And you only have him for 5 years.
You know what's sad?
If you don't like him.
You know what's sad? Since 2017, I hear that man calling radio and complaining. Since before that. That man calling and complaining about that water problem in Mova there for years. And I know the problem he having because a lot of people in Mova don't get water.
But I remember them days heavy. I tell them, TC, that when we come home from school, we had to know 4 buckets at the toad.
There's a big booster part in Mova there right by Petrode. Right? That's a big booster station there. You know that booster station there for? To make sure the water go over the lady don't have to cast it and sentence.
Oh,
but the people ain't moving and getting no water. Are they killing each other?
Nah, they're not taught water.
Of course not. The booster station is in Mova. And people were saying, well, how do you come? We have this big booster, WhatsApp booster station here, and we not get no water? No, that water, that booster station is not for you in Mova. That is to make sure the people of St. Anne's and Cascade over the hills of Bladion, make sure their water supply is concerned. In the meantime, they're scheduling water in Mova 2 days a week, 4 hours, one day, Tuesday, Wednesdays, and Friday, some plants, and sometimes in the night or the morning, they might get water.
All hours in the morning,
when the Cascade and St. Anne's people sleeping, you might get a little water in your pipe, and after that, you have to set up whole night and pull your bucket, full your tank, and in the morning, it's gone. This is how they're doing to we, right, Joe?
This is what I say. When they talk about unfair advantages, that's what we're talking about. When I'm family, they want to spend on the tote water, when the next one done bail and you're doing your homework. That is an unfair advantage.
All right, Kola.
We like it so, man.
We're going for a break.
Yeah.
Royal Castle is here, and the castle is making fasting easy and tasty. Come enjoy any of our 5 delicious fish options. All made with a fresh catch, seasoned local style, and cooked to golden perfection. Try the fish meal. 2 slices of fish with a side. The fish combo. 2 slices of fish, 1 side, and a drink. Maybe the fish sandwich combo of 1 sandwich, a side, and a drink. Want more fish? Well, the Royal Fish Meal is for you. Enjoy a slice of fish, a fish sandwich with a side and a drink. Or maybe you just want our famous fish sandwich. The delicious Lenten specials are hot and waiting for you at your nearest Royal Castle.
Here's a tasty meal tip from Royal Castle. Sometimes you just feel like eating a nice sandwich, right? The sensation of biting into a soft bun with the crunch of fresh lettuce and the taste of tomatoes along with added condiments all treat to your taste buds. At Royal Castle, our sandwiches are a hit. Try the center breast chicken and flying fish sandwiches, the wholesome veggie burger, and at selected locations, you can also get the grilled salad or grilled sandwiches. So when you get the craving, remember that the castle has some delicious sandwiches. Ask them in a combo too with your favorite side and a drink. Royal Castle, our culture, our taste.
This meal tip was sponsored by Royal Castle. Our culture, our taste.
Just watch it, doggy song. In little trap, behind God's back, see them reaching, hear them preaching.
Right, so we are back, Kevin. We are back. We are.
Yep.
We continue to take the phone calls. I see, I think Mr. West was calling us, right? But until he... All right, let me take this call. Good afternoon, welcome.
Hey, TC, very, very good program as usual. You know, I hope the PNN supporters listening to your program because, you know what I mean, that unit really going to know the truth. You know, I tell myself today, I'm feeling like Hakata. Well, every week now, we have movie night. You have Aquaman, you have Transformer, now this week, I think you have Mario Brothers now here this week. Last week, you didn't have a movie, free chicken and chips done, a pizza thing, man. I know the foolish little children and brainwash them and the family. I hope they wake up and understand that the last 8 years they didn't have nothing like that. Now election time coming next year, now every week is movie and chicken and chips. But you know, before I go, you know the government remind me of? In 2010 to 15. Kamala was the power. 8 years later, everything, when they listen to the other program and talk to everything, Kamala. So understand after 2015, 18, 19, okay, and they still blame Kamala. Right? Okay. Because 8 years now, they still blame Kamala. You remind me of a child. When a child going to school, and he failing the exam, he blame any teacher, and he blame any parent about that, you know? They come to say the government, you know, when they're incompetent, they find somebody to blame. So Kamala is the blame. You know, and again, for the PNN supporter, I want to open their eye after being brainwashed. They know the truth, you know, but you know what's the problem? Some of them are so racist. They don't want a better man. They don't want your black and human community. A warrior. We stop her, you know, but they're still warrior. They don't tell a grandchild and their child, go to PNN and tell them, and dig down the stopper in inside. Yeah? Because you know what? They don't want to tell the front color of this kid to help them. You understand? Because they realize that man who they call Lowry, he don't care about black people. And I want to hear that and understand that. He don't care about all the think about it. That's a lot. Very good show. Very, very good show.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Mr. West.
Yeah. Good afternoon, Mr. TC and Mr. Heavy.
Good afternoon.
It's good to know. I know this morning where that, when this afternoon, that the opposition, they are on the ground. And when people speak about and they comment in terms of the operations of the opposition, it's not destructive, but the people are on the ground and they should be happy to have that kind of feedback to know that the people on the ground and they're not seeing what they're seeing and what they're hearing. It's not a destructive criticism. It is constructive. It is to help them to know, you know, where the weaknesses are. Where they need to concentrate, what the feeling of the people are on the ground. So I don't think they should take it in bad light. They should use that as the barometer in terms of how they should actually go about their campaign by getting constructive feedback. Right? Another thing I'm talking about now is that I think on Friday, Mr. Heavy raised the issue of the property tax. And the opposition has made it quite clear They were very categorical with respect to it. And they said that they're going to review the whole thing. Right? They are not going to go along with the property tax. That's a ball of confusion. And this afternoon I had information that the government has suspended the property tax, right? The collection of payments and all that kind of thing. So it tells you, but the thing about it is that if the opposition did not say that they were going to review it, they would have gone along with it. The fact, because the politics in it, the question of votes and whatnot. So, and even when they say they suspend it, people must, but I don't know, simple things, and then the people in this country don't really understand. I don't know if they don't think it, where their minds are, you know, I don't know where the senses are. What they suspended all because it would cost them votes. And if in fact they suspend it and they call an election, you must not be fooled that they wouldn't bring it back. But the fact is, that is the job of the opposition, to educate the people, to act on the people's desire, their wish and whatnot. I mean, the risk must be reasonable and that kind of thing in any event. But the fact remains this, is that the PNM is on the run. The government is on the run. And I commend, because that thing was what brought tremendous hardship on poor people in this country. Right? And I'm commending them for taking that stand, that property tax. It has to be reviewed. Nobody say, well, look, you don't need to pay tax for your property and whatnot. But not at this time, more particularly. You haven't increased, as I said last week, you haven't increased the people, poor people, these pensioners, and that. You gave them nothing. You didn't give them a pen. You didn't give them 2%. So you taking off from the little they have, right, in order to pay property tax, for them to pay property tax. It's cruel. It's unkind. And you getting it to be something percent, which you say you put on hold because you want to hear what thing, and you, it's not that to say you don't want it, but the fact that you put it there, so send it back to the commission, whatever, sorry, the commission, to review it and to come up with that. That's nonsense. Right? So I commend the government, the opposition, for what they are doing, and I'm saying that they've been sensitive and responsive to public opinion. That is very important. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. West.
Wall Street, good afternoon.
Yo. TCN Heavy.
Yes, good afternoon, Wall Street.
How are you guys doing?
We're cool.
TCN Heavy. I told the people of Trinidad and Tobago that the property tax was regressive and oppressive. The chickens are coming home to roost. I am taking full credit, 100% credit, for letting the poor, black, disadvantaged people of Trinidad and Tobago know that property tax, the Prime Minister of Trinidad and Tobago, Colt Wilbert, Faris Alwari, Stuart Young, Terence Dial Singh shouldn't be paying the same 3% property tax as a poor, black, disadvantaged family in Lavantel and Mover environs. And listen, I am not ashamed to say poor, black, disadvantaged. Let those in the go-along, get-along, our PNM gang, come and talk about there's no black, disadvantaged people in Lavantel, Mover, Lavantel and environs. I want them to look at a video that was put out by CNC Tree about some people in Sealot. And they talk about a young man named Aline. Didn't show his face. He only used his voice. And another young kid said that all they're looking for is to get some food and for them to go to school. Because some days they cannot go to school. And then you hear the pastor with the internet search engine name playing the song, Poverty is No Excuse for Crime. How could he live peacefully, boy, and playing that type of song, boy? It has hurt my heart, you know. The Brookings Institute in Washington did a study on poverty and crime. Anybody in Trinidad could look it up. The Brookings Institute in Washington, D.C., a big institution that crime and poverty go hand in hand. And
hand in hand.
Heavy, I'm going to close with this. Hand in hand. Hand in hand. But the black PNM people, the 70 to 80% of them who continue to vote for the PNM, and is at the bottom of every socioeconomic statistics in Trinidad and Tobago.
Correct.
Listen, I'm saying every year, this is not one or two. Every socioeconomic statistics in Trinidad and Tobago, and the PNM has been in government for more than 75% of the time in Trinidad and Tobago.
Yep.
And black people at the bottom of every socioeconomic statistic. And lastly, somebody asked a question today. What you would like to see the PNM do for the upcoming general election? I thought the black PNM people that call and say, well, I want to see the 26% of black people living below the poverty line reduced. I would like to see the 18% of black people unemployment reduced. I would like to see that they give out 100 scholarships and 80%. I would like them to put in plans and policies. They give out 100 CAPE scholarship. 80% of the scholarship went to Indians, and the other 20 was divided with maybe the black folks getting 10%. And lastly, in the SEA, most of the black students scoring below 50%. I thought they would have called and say, these are the things they like to see because they're black. They didn't call and give one black improvement for the PNM to do for the 70 to 80% of them who vote for the PNM over and over. I say they like it. So, Evian TC, I thank you guys very kindly. And you guys have a splendiferous, marvelous, tremendiferous rest of the day. And I say to the people of Chumacac, Laventil, and environs, in the words of Eleanor Roosevelt, no one can make you feel inferior without your consent. Thank you very kindly. Bye bye.
Thank you very much for your call.
I'll go down to a book here as I forget to tell
you. You're going to do a book?
Gentlemen.
You're going to write a book?
Yeah.
To do what? To put away in
the. No. The book will be an audio book, that a novel.
The book is about water or heavy.
Kingsley, have you going to write a novel to put in the new library?
Yeah.
Indigo. So if you want that book, you have to go in the library and they go together.
This morning I hear one of my colleagues, Miss Sandra Cruz, and she make a lot of sense saying that Dr. Robbie take the laptop to build a library. And he says, Dr. Robbie take me. He said, no, but I factually know he take the laptop to build a library and PhD every single day in the library. PhD alone in that library they reading books. Boy. You'll be a doctor, Dr. Rowdy.
I want to write a book for PhD to read. The name of the book is the Education of Children. Yes.
I feel that book heavy. I think it was water. But I want to tell the gentleman who always called in on this program here, by name of Mr. West, I think you and this is calling. I get to know his name by every time he calls in or you say Mr. West.
Yeah.
And he makes some very intelligent words of understanding. I think that on this program here, he's our guru. He brings us a side of lecturer to the program. And I like that about him. He's still on board. He committed facts and his research of independent research, very independent research he do for country. He's not like them guru on them where they come one-sided of research of PNM. You know, some of the very bright, Long Junior, you know what I mean, Mr. Chance must be, but they come with one set of research only to defend the PNM. But when you hear Mr. West, he speak on national, nation building issues and what current affairs should be. That is Mr. West. I want to thank him very much for always lifting up this program with the high knowledge of this politics. But as we continue, Evie and TC, you know this government today, and only thing I was disappointed with the last program day, that nobody in calling to support me by saying that the government should be paying Shilma to go in all these primary schools and speak she life of hard times. And I thought that the PNM callers
to pay who?
Would like, show my version to be a lecturer, going to the school in Mova, Beatham, you know what I mean, Sealot, Belmont, Gonzalez, Diego Martin, you know what I mean, Enterprise, Arima, San Fernando, Pinal.
Kingsley, why would they do that? She was on the last show, what?
Yeah, so the last
show. I don't know.
Or she lifestyle of which she been through, which she was born, and the kind of life she did, think that she stands strong as a young, as a black lady, you know what I mean? And very strong lady. And I know she's a very strong lady. You also know her too, heavy. I don't know how good her amputee know her, but she's a very strong, strong lady. And I think that I was hoping that the PNM callers call in and promote the government more to promote Shoma on a spotlight. But they ain't calling. Why they ain't calling? Shoma, I love you. Shoma, oh God, Shoma, you're doing good. Shoma, you're inspired. Shoma, your son. Shoma, your son. Shoma. And no one out there say, hey, Dr. Rowley, you see, Shoma, we need Shoma in these poverty ghettos to talk to the young girls and the young boys. And you know, up and out, they do that. Only Shoma, I love you. Shoma, look at PNMake. PNMake a bright son. And PNMake a bright. Nothing about the government. And that is why Dr. Rowdy turned us all by the old Ramban and not to. Because, hey, what he do here? In that area, they it have Picton, John John, Pump Chase, or Big Chile, Beatham, Sealot. This zone is a warring faction zone. You go and build houses in the middle, the same way how we take desperados and put them in the middle of Duncan Street and Nelson Street and says they belong. That's what he said though. They belong. Right? Two warring faction zone where he put desperados and he said desperados membership because desperado membership from back in the days are PNM. So he said it was easy for them to move from Shaggy Road Day for now that they're going to build a homeless day. He said it was very easy. He get no opposition from the leader and the band. And you know that by facts, don't is not a world-class thing. We have a world-class to support us Spain. To support us Spain, already deceitful boy. We have a world-class pantheater in Desperados in Lavender. A world-class, world international five-star. I went with a plan to bring back up Desperados on the hill. I went to Mr. Paul's, and these people reject me. They make bacchanal confusion. And Dr. Rowdy is lying. Because he know that theater, that pandetta of this. Right? Because I was a part of that pandetta. I support young pan down the hill of Desperados. How you could put a pan in two warring zones and say they belongs. I ask the question. How was Pan Dongdi? How much? And you know something? Imagine that, eh? When they keep in the thing, it's like a police Dongdi, no? Because nobody in working on this shit, this Dongdi shit, and this shit where, you know, people in some people have machine and thing. So, we again, Dongdi with the father is not no world class, is a PNM base, a PNM party group. The real desperados remain on the hill of Lavantel. That right now we have a junior theater to teach young people how to be pan. Don't we have up there? These two buildings there is like white elephant pan store up inside there, and our pan theater and the whole, because we have a pan yard there. That was a original pan yard in Desperados. I know something. None of these pan men never fight from a cabin. They take what Dr. Rowdy to them on Shaggy Road and then move them and say he put them now with the deserve.
Thank you, Kingsley.
Oh, Lord, there are some voice notes. Let me see if I can run all these voice notes before we hit the top of the hour.
Yeah.
TC, good afternoon. TC, that shooting, you see there. They said I thought the police was searching that man. right? They said the police was searching a man and shot him accidentally. And that really word on the ground. And, right? They were searching him and he was shot accidentally.
About 2 hours ago, that shooting took place, or maybe a little.
Loving the house. Loving the house, heavy. Loving the house, DC. Loving the house, Trinidad and Tobago. But I see now, when talking, only seeing a similar pattern when you check about. First to begin, only ever find the Prime Minister, Dr. Rowley, with all them shocking acts and them news about them little children. You ever find that moving like a surprising? He was shocking. He ever addressed the nation like if this thing is really bothering him. No, it's not bothering me. This is a similar incident like Akil Chambers would have find floating in a swimming pool where he's only adults there with suit and jacket and tie, a whole bunch of ballies there. Up to now, none of them don't want to know. They're trying to find out how that happened. If somebody bring a man jump in there, I don't want to see that. Look at our house in Valsen, look how long that going on. Them don't want to interfere with that. All kind of report make, people make report here, there and everywhere. These people in surprise with these things were happening like it's a shocking news to we. But it's not a shocking news to certain people, but you see what's going on with the children and these people are experimenting on the children. Leave the whole family vulnerable, the mother, the father came and works with the children. Hey, people selling the children like with these nasty people. We going through this in our country, we had too much money. Not no money, no, we had too much money. It's 1.4 million people here, and we going through this, people suffering, people selling themselves for zero, less than nothing. Look at what's going on with this. Only seen a similar pattern. Only seen a similar pattern. Look what's going on with Akil Chambers. It was not child's play or a camp of children playing. It's a big people, a big adult content he was in as a youth man, one child there. How come that happened? Nobody trying to find out that this whole bunch of ball is packed up there. Whole bunch of ballies, you know, and all of them still up in my face playing the governing with laws and with children laws, you know. Me don't respect them people, but plenty of them feel some TV show going on out here, you know. That's why I realize them people, you know, this is reality, brother. And we and my children is victim of this whole evil system this man come up with here, boy. Just what I tell you, all ain't done, you know, all ain't enough of this yet, you know. Because me care who on the other side. Me don't care about who on the other side, brother. The devil and all his followers, let them go so on the other side. Let the devil and his followers go so too. At the end of the day, love in your house, right?
Love in the house, respect and manners.
Yes, we go so we're going for a break. For the next,
it's a little too long, so I can't play that one until we'll just play all the voice notes that we have there when we come back around and jump into some more conversation, all right?
Well, so, give them some bone by the time.
Give them some bone, give them some bone.
After election, all the bone done. So, come and touch it. Don't look so shocked. Don't just watch it. Don't be sad.
Season changes, let's continue to show that ocean of unity for each other. Let's harmonize that sweet rhythmic sound that comes from deep within, that reflects togetherness, getting back to the issues that matter the most. One mission, one station, the Street 919 FM.
The views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
You've got bills to pay, and so do we. Let's go pay some bills on the Street 919 FM.
Tune in to the Street 919 FM every second, third, and fourth Thursday at 8 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. Welcoming you to Reset with Dr. Livett, your weekly guide to holistic health and wellness. As we dive deep into the worlds of holistic health, from ancient herbal remedies to cutting-edge holistic practices, we'll explore it all. Join Dr. Livett with over 11 years of experience as a holistic health practitioner, healer, and master herbalist as he shares invaluable insights to help you reset your mind, body, and spirit. Reset with Dr. Livett every second, third, and fourth Thursday at 8 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. Only on The Street 919 FM. Join the winning team with Pastor Alkaline John every Tuesday at 11.05 a.m. to 12 noon and every Wednesday night from 7.05 p.m. to 8 p.m. live on The Street 919 FM as he talks about LaVive, the power of five fruits, one of the most powerful antioxidant supplements on the market today. The five superfruits in LaVive are mangosteen, acai, pomegranate, goji, and nuni. These fruits have a positive and profound impact on human health performance and disease. Join him as he gives live testimonials of the LaVive healing powers. To get more information, you can contact Pastor Alkaline John at 516-286-7079 or you can visit his webpage at www.alkalinejohn.com. Remember, every Tuesday at 11.05 a.m. and Wednesday at 7.05 p.m. live on The Street 919 FM.
If you want greater respect from your bankers, bosses, those in authority, then words matter. If you want more productive business relationships with co-workers, customers, or clients, then join Dr. Madonna on The Street 919 FM every Monday, 11 a.m. to 12 noon for Words Matter, communication for joyful workplaces. Dr. Madonna will help you unlock the secret power of words for your financial, relationship, and physical well-being. Whether you work at home, on the road, or in an organization, join Dr. Madonna every Monday, 11 a.m. to 12 noon for Words Matter, communication for joyful workplaces.
Job Optimum Health and Wellness. Are you sick and tired of being sick and tired? Get your Bioplasma Diagnostic Full Body Scan. Examines all of your organs in a single session. 95% accuracy. It's painless, non-invasive, and affordable. Call Pastor Job at 350-2628, 767-1031, or 275-6300. Sick and tired of being sick and tired? Get your Bioplasma Diagnostic Full Body Scan at Job Optimum Health and Wellness.
The Spiritual Baptist Faith celebrates the 73rd anniversary of the repeal of the Shouters Prohibition Ordinance of 1917. Get ready. On Friday the 22nd of March 2024, there's a traditional open-air wayside service at Isaac Junction, Kuva. Time will be 7 p.m. Dress code, national colors. Come and hear some dynamic men and women of God expound the gospel of Jesus Christ. On Monday, 25th of March 2024, come and participate in opening of the second entrepreneurial village from 6 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. Men of Valor service at 7:45 p.m. to 9 p.m. Dress code blue. Tuesday, the 26th of March 2024, Spiritual Baptist Village exhibition, which commences from Tuesday, March 26th to Thursday, 28th March 2024. Time 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. DOC's presentation, Tuesday to Thursday at 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. Youth for Christ service at 6 p.m. Dress code white. Wednesday, 27th March 2024, Woman of Substance service at 6 p.m. Dress code will be pink. Thursday, the 28th of March 2024, Mylad Spiritual Baptist Experience at 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. The Spiritual Baptist Diaspora service at 6 p.m. Dress code colored. All events will take place at the Spiritual Baptist Administrative Complex off Balmain Road, Hoover, near to the Atabolan Stadium. See you there.
Tune in to The Street 919 FM every Friday from 9:15 a.m. to 9:45 a.m. with Kingdom Health Services, situated at number 125 to 186 Eastern Main Road in Tuna Puna, 4th the program, Health and Healing, merging the old with the new, with Mr. Brent Diet. For more information, call 318-7471 or 484-0141 or 360-4100. It's all about Kingdom Health Services on the street, 919 FM.
Turn your lights down low and listen to the Master's radio. Get in touch with God. Turn your radio on.
You are invited to join Pastor Morris Johnson of the Church of the Firstborn Assembly Miracle Center, located at number 399 Eastern Main Road, Waiko, in Sangre Grande, for the all-time gospel hour family radio ministry, every Sunday from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. On Mondays, 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., trauma and bereavement. Also, every Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., the low and you. Wednesdays from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., dealing with disabilities. And every Friday evening from 9 p.m. to 5 a.m., the all-night prayer live on the street, 919 FM, designed with you in mind. This program deals with the day's issues from a biblical perspective, and you'll also be given the opportunity to call in and interact with us. Micah 6:8 says, "He hath showed you, O man, what is good, and what doth the Lord require of you, but to do justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with your God." Your financial support through the First Citizens Bank will be greatly appreciated. Account number 795-222. For further information, call 753-1113 or 610-4673.
The views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
Share the line.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM.
TC and every blessed evening. So I was listening to the fake pastor number this evening there, right? And one of them post-primary graduates and them from Tobago calling. Right? Anyway, this PDP, yeah? One of them post-primary graduates and them from Tobago calling and saying that, remember that Kamala to leave money to leave on the country for 3 days. So what I call the fake pastor and ask him, well, if it is, it had money to run the country for 3 days, how it is that Dr. Rowley kept the country running still, right? He can't answer that. I said, explain to me the ladder on them that they purchased, the 20 ladder on them that they purchased. Explain to me what going on with that. He can't answer that. He can't explain that. You understand? And you know the man didn't even play that recording, boy, when I was talking to him, because he know the kind of stupidness they'll be pushing out there, because I got like them to explain how it is that Rowley, you understand, run the country on 3 days' money, and the country was still running after that. You understand, he ain't go by the IMF or nothing like that, right? But I guess fools will always be fools, you understand? So let it go to that kind of stupid narrative now, boy.
Good afternoon, TC and Heavy. I just want to touch on this whole SSA background that going on. Could you guys tell me who appointed the head of the SSA, this guy that they sent home? And is it that the government wants us to believe that the SSA could be paying somebody $25,000 a month, man of company card, the SSA sent him to Israel, all kind of thing, and the cabinet have no idea about what's going on? So you try to tell me a government agency could just hire somebody, pay them $25,000 a month, get them company vehicle, all kind of thing to drive, and the that don't have to get approval from at least the National Security Council or the cabinet. That ain't sounding right to me, you know. That ain't sounding right to me at all. If you remember when government changed, one of the first things they did was to fire all the people I was working, which was then the SIA, right? Now it's the SSA. They fire all the people. If you could take your mind back, the former head took them to court for wrongful dismissal, and he won the case and everything like that. So who is the one who appointed this Roger Best man as the head of the SSA? For a ghost, he appointed himself, you know? I mean, the government want us to believe that the SSA operating on its own and not accountable to nobody, and nobody, it doesn't have a line minister, it doesn't have to go back to the prime minister or anything. That's all I'm right to tell you.
Good afternoon, everyone, DC. Every year, I want to speak about this property tax. One of my friends get a paper, her rental value is $18,000. Her bill is $972. The Prime Minister said, Dr. Keith Rowley said, it's 3% of the rental value. When I do 3% of $18,000, I get in $540. How her bill is $972? The government is lying to us, and they're not telling me the truth, the exact figure of the percentage of the rental value that we have to pay.
I think after you take away 3% from the 18,000, you had to multiply it by some number. Wherever you get from the 3% of where they say rental value is, they're multiplying it by something else, and that way again the figure. I don't know too much about it, and I refuse to know much about it, because to me, it's unnecessary. To me, that property tax, as I say, I done give me 2 cents about that property tax already. I am saying to you that property tax is a hoax. It's a way to thief money, because what they are not saying, and I will say it again, what they are not saying is that who is collecting the property tax, where it is going when it's collected, and who is responsible for distributing or dispersing that funds back into the community. Because the claimant says that they had to pay the property tax in order to get the garbage picked up and the roads clean and all these things and infrastructure and whatever in your community. Right? And that whole property tax issue was based around local government reform. And local government reform hasn't been done yet. So how come they want to introduce the tax first when they even fix local government? You don't need money to fix the local government reform. That is just policy. You understand?
So when it gets into play, it have money there to start to put things in one
time. That is making no sense, you see. Don't send me that doc here and tell me it's for whoever it is, you see.
Good afternoon, TC and Heavy. The reason why the government didn't have to go to no IMF is because they, thanks to Manning and Cameron, they put in money, a lot of money, what, 11 billion and something, or 12 billion US into the Heritage and Stabilization Fund. That's why they ain't go to the IMF, because they depend on it all the time. They're putting nothing, but they depend on it all the time. So that is why the whole country run, because of the vision of Manning and Cameron, they who have that money inside there, right? Putting in that money in the Heritage and Stabilization Fund. So that's what they're using for. That's why you can't go to the IMF as yet. Yeah, even but are not using for me to do your own business. And people don't get sidetracked by the government trying to play down the property tax now, because if all them make the mistake and put them in power again, property tax and all them other high prices and taxes coming again, so what's all they doing?
Please just accept without asking questions.
Every according to your language yesterday, your maths not maxing is not multiply. When you get a yearly figure from the 3%, you divide it by 12 to get a monthly figure. Divide, not multiply.
But you hear I now say I don't know what to think of something with that. I don't know. Didn't you hear I said I don't know? And I don't care to know? You understand? You laughing, ha ha ha. I said that. I think you had to divide it or multiply it by some other figure or something. I don't know. So how come you say, and I say something that I didn't say? You more stupid than me? You had to be, were you here indifferent? I never quote no figures or say what it was supposed to be. I tell him, based on the voice note, right? He said the woman paying 18,000 and she get 900, and when she's divided by 5, I find that is too much math. I find that is making no sense. I find it, we should be paying those property taxes. When I get that paper, I rip it up. That might take, that's my opinion. and I'm entitled to it. Let me move on. That's the last voice note?
That's the last voice.
So, let's move on. We're talking about no property tax here today. Because that, in itself, we too gullible. I like to just follow. I don't like Trinidadians. I don't know, boy. Now they take all the passive, quiet, humble slaves and put them on this island. You understand? We just take. I still shocked that we boycott KFC. I told you that never stand up for nothing. And I had to give kudos to that because guess what? That's the only thing we stand up for. Yeah. You understand? Everything else we just take. We actually take a property tax. We take in right after this property tax, look up for the high light bill coming in the tail, you know. High electricity bill in the Rukunkutunkung, and then on top of that, high water rate too, because you're wasa getting on right now. You understand? They go down and say that they raise the price up, that raise the water bill. You understand?
Yep.
Right. They don't want to charge you for using your hose and all kind of stupidness. So we have to understand that we in Trinidad and Tobago here, right? We're not supposed to be even going through what we're going through. Right? We're too gullible. And I just want to say some words here, but. And I'm saying all of us, because they have a sensible one. Some of us very educated and have common sense. There's a difference between having common sense and being educated there, because that's some educated people don't have no common sense at all. You understand? They're supposed to be born with that. Right? And then have those who have common sense and not too bright. But at least your common sense could tell you right from wrong. And that's all it is, right from wrong. You must be able to decipher what is right and what is wrong. You understand? And they say a child from the age of 7 years old should know the difference between right and wrong. And as from the age of 11, you're supposed to decipher what is right and what is wrong. But some of us acting like we're 3, 4, and 5 years old still. Because we're trying to make right wrong and wrong right according to who we supporting and who the party. Big, high, bad people in the 50s and 60s, they want to make wrong right. They want to make it right by saying somebody else to do it or them to do it. So that make it right because them to do it. But then if them to do it and it was wrong, then you're not supposed to do it, if you understand where I'm coming from.
Exactly, and that's what I'm telling you. If UNC lose an election on the basis of the things that this country stand and say, yo, we're not taking that from the UNC, right?
Right.
And they say, we're not taking that crime, we're not taking the corruption, we're not taking the this and that, then PNM sure lost the next election.
Exactly. But no, they want to make it sound like, right, everything that is happening now, what this PNM government is doing, right, it's because of that party. So that party, they do it, so them it's okay for them to do it now.
Foolishness.
So then where should I leave them? Let them continue doing it?
Foolishness.
That match not matching either. So I need a little... Well, I can't tell them wake up and open their eyes because they're in the dark. As mommy says, she eyes... She can't see. Oh, God. Right? I listened to the radio yesterday. On coming here and I hear a woman and an elderly tanty voice, you hear she winter years, and you know what she's saying. And I don't know whether they want to come back in power for after they leave the country, money to run the country for 3 days. TC, I'll drive in and I'll run off the lady on coming to work. Because I listen to that, and I'm saying, mommy still believe that the UNC leave only money for 3 days to run the country.
Sad.
Right? And next one calling to say, yes, they want to come back to lock up all the black people and them. They want to do it. Like, what do they do? And I'm saying, Lord, they believe in the propaganda. TC, they believe in the propaganda.
Yes,
you understand? What they're saying is what they're hearing people saying, no.
Yeah.
They have no proof, facts, or evidence. We had also closed on Petrochem. Petrochem was milking this country dry. Lie. And we have the facts to prove it. The 3 days propaganda. We have a whole video where we're already showing you the draft.
Yeah.
Now they're coming with property tax. They're coming with this, they're coming with that. I saying to myself, they keep saying they have no money. So how they turning such a bill, millions and millions of dollars, CC? Yeah. Where that money coming from? They keep saying we had to cut and tighten with bed and tighten with bed. They can't pay 4%. They can't pay more than 4% because they have no money. So where they getting money to finish build the hospital and all these things? Where the money come from? Where the money come from for a flyover to facilitate 10 people? In a 10 people or 100 people. Imagine that. You build a whole flyover and spend millions of dollars to facilitate 100 people, TC?
Yeah.
Not to facilitate a borough, you know? Not to facilitate a village, you know? Not to facilitate a city, you know? You build a whole flyover and spend millions of dollars to facilitate some 1% people living in some condominiums. Because they decide they don't want to drive up the road to turn on to come back over the traffic light. Where you get that money from? I thought we had no money.
We have no money for us.
Correct. It's have no money for poor people.
I have no money for us.
And somehow, nobody's talking. I want to tell you something, naturally, and Tobago, this evening. You are not hearing this government on no media platform, no political platform, no platform at all, speaking about their plan to solve our economic problems. They plan to solve the high unemployment problems in Trinidad and Tobago. They plan to solve the most of what's supposed to be on the front burner, the high crime problem in Trinidad and Tobago, how to fix it. Their plan how to boost the economy, right? And get direct foreign direct people to come in here and create jobs and employment. Foreign direct investment, you're not hearing no plan at all. From then they hit a platform, they start to talk about people. Right? They start to talk about this one and that one. And imagine them in the UNC, they come to talk about me. And them, this one had this one. And that one had do this. And this one before the court.
Yeah,
and who calling my name? Who calling my name? They should call. And They're not talking about nothing to fix nothing with we in this country. To fix nothing that we're going through. They're not talking nothing. All they're talking is bacchanal and Kushume politics and racial divide and who do this and who do that. Yeah? And they want to tell me about crime and you listen to that. Eh? You listen to that. Listen to that. And then listen. Go on YouTube and just type in the president of Guyana and listen to how we talking any speech. And here we talking about what you going to do for your country. Eh? And compare that to our prime minister's speech. And how we talking. Worse yet, Mayor Motley. Go on YouTube and type in Mayor Motley, President of Barbados, Prime Minister of Barbados, and they go see, watch her speech and listen what she's talking. All they're talking is for they're going to do this for, so the people can get her ease up there, or they're going to do this. Even the Jamaica Prime Minister, go and watch he speeches when he talking. What he going to do? How we going to do it? You understand? What is to come? What do you have for this? What you plan to do this? And what you plan to do that for your country? They acting like we okay? Everything nice and hunky-dory? And they could just go and say, well, you see the opposition? They want to talk about me? And all of before the court for this and before the court for that and who teeth this and who teeth that and this and that.
Dreams about who is the richest. Check and see who is the richest in the country.
Yeah, go and check and see who's the richest in the country.
The richest in the country, they didn't put the name up there. All they didn't know that. The richest in the country, they didn't put the name up there. You understand? It sense make me fall, but you must know. You understand? All they running down the wrong set of them could have threw that for it to run down.
I really and truly is want to tell these sycophants, if they really just listen or understand, or if you want to hear Bacchanal and Chan Jat and Couture, if that is what you want, in order for you to vote. Or you just want to hear the other side, this and this, them is that, and them is that, and them is that, and them is that, for you to vote? Well, it's okay. Then you listen to this show from morning to evening to 4 o'clock. Right?
No, but on a real, a lot of them is Bacchanal and Couture to vote. You know that. That's what have been embedded. Information wasn't embedded into them. Because if information was embedded into them, heavy,
mm-hmm.
right, then they would have seen long time
yep.
where the failure was coming from.
Correct.
Right? They'd be honest. If information was something that they were given, right, to the people of Trinidad and Tobago, then they would have, the people of Trinidad and Tobago would have seen by now where we have been making the same mistakes over and over and over. But every time election comes around,
mm-hmm.
it is some kind of thing coming out of some closet or some kind of gate or some kind of this or some kind of that. Because you ever watch the build up to election anywhere else in the, like that I like to say about America and Europe.
Mm-hmm,
part.
Mm-hmm,
you ever watch the build up towards an election in these places?
Mm-hmm.
Where the two people who is going to vie for that spot.
It's been a debate and
it has been debates.
Yeah. And they're talking on policy and different policy. Yeah.
Policy.
What are they gonna do when they do? Yeah, and they're asking them questions and they're answering it.
Right. Mm-hmm. It's like when they go for Miss Universe now.
Yeah.
There's not no Bacchanal and Couture by no corner in
there. Nope.
Right? Now, hear what has gone. You see the man who holding on to his spot?
Yeah.
Right? When he reaching the debate, he better be able
to answer
for what he had debated on the last time.
Yeah.
Because the people in those countries don't forget.
No, they remember.
They would remember that, yo.
You told us the last time that you was going to do this, and that, and fix that.
Right. How much of that have you done?
Yeah. Have you accomplished any of those? Yeah.
If that was not accomplished, you know what's going on with you?
Yeah, you can't talk to them.
Thank you, Heavy. So, if that was the way election have been fought throughout the Caribbean, mm-hmm. now you call some islands there that now they are changing the dynamics
mm-hmm.
because in for instance, Mia Motley want to stay Mia Motley for the
she want to stay long in power. Mm-hmm.
You could actually, she actually doing and
she's like
a Caribbean leader.
She moving like Barbados alone. She moving like a Caribbean leader.
Right.
Yeah.
So when you watch her, and then now you're realizing the Guyanese prime minister taking pattern.
Yeah.
The Jamaican taking pattern is not too late for them.
Yeah.
It is not too late for them because, hear what? Them realize now, hey, have a generation that is coming here that you can't feed that old school.
That old school, the long time Bacchanal thing, yeah.
You cannot. You will catch some, but the mass majority standing there with their hands open, waiting.
Correct.
Their hands open.
Correct.
Times hard.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And people are talking about times they had in Trinidad alone. That is truth. Times they had in Trinidad alone. Times hard all over the world.
Yeah.
But the other leaders
Fixing the problem
so try to make their countries
better. Correct.
You understand? So when we talking and trying to play this and look what them do and them all them kind of thing.
Yeah.
We losing. We continuously losing. Because at some point, as you say,
mm-hmm.
and you just say some real things and people don't understand why they just cuss you.
Yeah, they don't understand.
Right? Mm-hmm. At some point, there will be no more PNM for real.
Yeah.
Because at some point, the elders who still believe in Eric Williams and still believe in what Eric Williams did, mm-hmm. whether it was right or wrong, I am not here to judge him.
Mm-hmm.
You just judge him. You just mm-hmm. say, he think, right, I am not going, I different.
Right.
They believe in that. And they believe that they owe him something. So they hold on to the PNM.
Right.
Right? Two things I know for sure. Sure. PNM is one of the most sturdy party in Trinidad and Tobago. You can't fight that.
Mm-hmm.
They are more sturdy than any other party in Trinidad.
Mm-hmm.
And I also know for sure that they didn't do best for the interests of Trinidad and Tobago.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not talking about just the communities that they're supposed to see about, right? I'm not talking about just the Lavantels and the East West Corridor and the this mm-hmm. and the that, right? I'm talking about
the country in general.
Yeah. They did not do the best that they could have done for the country.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Knowing that, I can't vote for them. That's what I could tell you.
Right.
You understand? Because at the end of the day, if they're not doing the best for the country, then I pass in that. And when I say
not
country,
only you, not only you, your children and everybody.
Right. For the people who cussing me and saying how he can say they do best for the country,
yeah.
I'm going to show you a few ways how they didn't do best for the country. And then we're going to take some phone calls. Right? Well,
go ahead.
You see that? Inflation and food?
Mm-hmm.
Where every citizen has to face it.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody can get away from that.
Right.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
That is not doing best for the country.
Nope.
Right? See the crime rate? Where every citizen, whether it reached by you yet? It is affecting you. It's affecting you. You can say what you want.
Mm-hmm.
It is affecting you.
Mm-hmm.
Right? In some form or fashion, the crime rate.
It's affecting me.
It's affecting everybody. Right?
Yes.
Right. So then, you're not making the best choices because up to now,
mm-hmm.
as the commanding man who is leading the ship,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
If the man who reading the GPS for the ship cannot read properly the GPS and he keep us throwing us off course,
yeah.
move him and try somebody else. And I have been saying,
correct.
I have no personal problem with Mr. Hines. I'm saying he's just not performing where he's there.
Mm-hmm.
Move him and let me try somebody else. But no, nevertheless.
How about the commissioner of police too?
Nevertheless, well, the commissioner of police is only a product of a failed whole system.
Right.
Right? So I'm not even blaming the commissioner. Right? It is the commissioner is only there because of a system that failed.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So that system start higher than her. Right? Because if he had moved the Minister of National Security,
mm-hmm.
right? Then maybe the Commissioner of Police may have been a different police commissioner. I don't know.
Right.
Right? But it starts somewhere. Somebody had to press down for the whole thing to press down, down, down for it to reach the ground, right?
Right, right.
Right. So that is affecting the country. Mm-hmm. And why? This way that you want to be taxing everything.
Everything you want to tax.
Everything you want to tax. Every way you could find to.
Like your solution for everything is tax.
Yes. $1,000 for a ticket. In that 9 years, it moved from how much? 200 was for tickets.
Six tickets to
$1,000.
And some tickets is 2,000. 2,000 only, but shouldn't it?
Right. So. Let me say from 500 up.
Up.
I don't even think it's a $500
ticket. No 500 right? ticket again.
So, everything now, you move a ticket from being one something and 200 to $1,000.
Yeah.
That is a draconian
move. Draconian.
Right?
And in a time when cost of living got up.
Yeah.
Right? The gas rate seven
the
times.
Gas, that is affected everybody.
Yeah. That's right? not draconian.
Right? So, all it costs me. And then. You come now and you implement this property tax thing where nobody understands it up to now clearly.
Clearly, yeah. Nobody understands.
Nobody understands
up to now clearly. Yeah.
I want you to understand what I'm telling you here.
Yeah.
Nobody understands it clearly.
Mm-hmm.
All you're telling people is when you get the amount, take 3% for it, from it, yeah, and then divide it by 30 and add 20 and give you 50, yeah, and then it's a whole set of up and down and wrong and wrong.
Yeah. In a circle, it, right? It's like they put that sort of fool you.
Right.
They just don't want to tell you, all right, you have to pay
this
that.
This is how much you have to pay.
Yeah, yeah.
Why not? Why didn't you,
mm-hmm,
right?
Yeah.
You done evaluate my property.
Yeah.
You know the maths behind it. It's very simple to just sit down and ta-ta-ta.
But even like the Prime Minister and all don't know either, because when the man asked him the question, how come a smaller property next to my neighbor and my next neighbor property bigger than that? He paid more than my neighbor property who bigger. Well, yeah, that's not like Prime Minister tell him. If you had a house, you don't have to pay no tax and all kind of shit. He like, yeah, no, no, no.
Thank you. So things like this, heavy, will affect the wider public, because housing,
yeah,
everybody have to have somewhere
to live. Correct.
Whether you're renting or not, you have to have somewhere to live, right?
Yep.
Gas, everybody has to move around. Whether you have your own vehicle or you're traveling,
you have to move around. So, of course, price of transportation going up. Goods and services going up. Crime going up.
Right. And I mean, go healthcare or nothing. I didn't go there yet.
Yeah,
because there are people that could pay and go private. But crime, high cost of living, the taxation of everything, these things here, why I just point out there,
yeah,
give me the reason why I should say they ain't do a good job at all.
Correct.
In 9 years. Correct. Right? Who wanna cost me tomorrow?
They could turn on my side, they could build on my building.
And then that we don't know already, that's just politics playing.
Yeah.
That is only politics. You had 9 years to turn sod. To show now, after 9 years, going into this one here, look what we do.
Yeah.
That could be the thing that you could beat your chest like King Kong.
Yeah.
And say, look what we do. After all, let's say we do nothing. We build this, we build that, we take
it. But when you build that, that helping we personally, you know.
Well, it may help a certain sector to get some
job. Alright, but you need to do something that will directly affect everybody pocket and make sure that everybody feeling good.
While I understand you, right? And I side with you there. It would have still put a little bread in some people's mouth.
Who? But right? What is this? What billion now that could put bread in people's mouth?
I'm not saying no. I'm saying if it had happened, like if they had done some massive projects back then.
Oh, projects!
Right. Meaning, just like what Mr. Manning did, right? When he did...
The problem with the projects, you see, all with a claim to city bill, is the same contractors billing all the same projects and they're not giving nobody no work.
Well, the work did well trickle down to still a little missing and a little.
No, it's not trickling down. This is the problem that we're having. No, the work what man they do in the waterfront and all them building and things. I had no work there and I was no tradesman.
Right.
You understand where I'm coming from? The shit up. You understand where I'm coming from? So a small contractor give subcontracts to other people and all them things. Now you have the same contractors
doing the same
jobs.
Let's hear from Trinidad and Tobago. We had a lot to say there, right? I know the phone lines was ringing, so let me hear from you. What do you think about the whole situation that we just spoke about and everything, right? We'd love to hear from you, all right? See some voice notes came in as well. So let me play the voice notes, all right?
Good afternoon, TC, and good afternoon, Heavy. One thing I always say about this Prime Minister named Keith Netanyahu Rowley, the man say when he went to lecture, he say you have to make the rich richer to employ the poor, but the rich getting richer and selling home the poor. That's number one. Number two, the partner, the short man, this Imsbert man, he raised the gas once, raised it twice, and nobody riot yet. That alone, I sign it with PNM, I sign it with our government. Them don't care nothing about poor people. Blessed Lord.
Heavy, good afternoon, buddy. Tell TC his mic needs fixing. His mic need fixing. TC mic need fixing. From since yesterday, TC keep going and coming, his mic need fixing. Right? I'd like if you all could take some time before you come on here and check your mic and stuff, right? Because TC singing real, real, real far away from his mic. All right, locked on and listening, guys.
Right, Evie. So, that's the voice notes. We have a nice voice note there. All right. We have two more. As soon as it learns, but we can take your call as well.
Yeah, we're taking your calls.
We're taking your calls as well. 342-0081 and 466-5391. I don't know what's oh, look at now pop up.
Well, now, Heavy. Good afternoon, partner. Yes, are you well seen always there in the chat group? They go hear them callers, them PNM callers telling you that, yes, are you well seen now? I'm going to offer up my condolences to the Jumbo family. That man is an icon in the cricketing age, and also in the football age. That fella used to be there throwing them nuts accurate, you know. And they had a commercial about him too, I ain't know if they know about that. Jumbo nuts. Rest in peace, partner. He was a true patriot of Trinidad. Later, fellas. That is good news coming from Dr. West there. Because this property tax is a draconian, wicked piece of legislation, you understand? When they can put people through property tax and they have no tribunal to assess if the payment they're making is correct or not, and they will tell you to pay it still, that is wrong. And that is one reason for it to be stopped. And I'm glad they stopped it. You cannot start something and you don't have people in place to measure what the people property tax is about. If they're right or wrong, if the figures they're getting is a correct payment or not, and then tell them pay it, and then they go see it. You set up no assessment board, Mr. Inbert. That's the kind of foolishness they're doing for our government. You can imagine what's going on in his finance ministry that we don't know about. Have a good day, fellas.
Yeah, man. Thanks so much for your contribution. Already. While we are with the calls, you can go ahead. All right.
I just want to go back to. Go back to what we are talking, because you mentioned something about other countries when they're doing, when they're having elections.
Right.
And you mentioned America with the debates and things that was happening. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know why, for the life of me, we in Trinidad, I was about Tobago when I'm talking this, because Tobago to me, a little more politically intelligent than us here. We in Trinidad don't vote on policy.
Yeah. Always party.
Always party and race.
Always party, yeah. Always party.
We don't care if we're not getting no water.
Yeah.
We're not getting no water. Right? And you're not getting no water how many years? 30-something years, you're not getting a proper running supply of water.
Can I take this one?
Go ahead.
Caller, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, TC and Heavy.
Good afternoon. You're speaking very soft.
Good afternoon, TC and Heavy.
Good afternoon.
Take your headset out your ears.
I have nothing on my ears. It's my phone.
Well, boy, you're coming in very soft. Very soft.
I don't know why you're coming in that soft. But go ahead. All
right. But in America, it doesn't have no one party to win election. They have two parties, Republic and Democrat. No other party. Just two parties. The 3-4 party join up to win an election. That don't make sense at all. That should never be. That's nice. Thank you.
That didn't make no sense at all, what you just said there, Cola.
Nope.
Because in America...
America politics is different to us.
It's different. What I'm saying is the debate that they have, because of the... They know they have to do their job to keep their job.
Correct.
Right? For old people like Oledo Tinkana. For a big old man like Oledo Tinkana. Cool. When I spoke about American politics, right? I spoke about American politics being, right? They want to keep their job. so they will do their job.
Correct.
For some big
and the people will make sure they are comfortable.
Really, really dance.
The people will make sure they are comfortable.
They are comfortable.
For them.
Yeah. Hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, TC, and good afternoon, heavy and TV listeners as well. You know, I hear all your frustration, eh? But unfortunately, as long as Kamala is leading the UNC heavy duty, you won't get your wish of removing Dr. Olia and the PNM. And I could explain to you from many angles why. You see, Kamala needs to understand what a couple of words are. Things like integrity, self-respect. You don't make room in your party for people who say all kind of derogatory things about you. You understand? If Gary Griffin doesn't get his way.
Hold on. Before I even go further, I just want to correct you on one thing. Hold on, because I know we're fans, all right? You know there's a radio host on this station said derogatory things about Dr. Rowley?
Yes. Many people
real derogatory things, red sting things. And now that same radio host is speaking on behalf of that same party?
Yes, and you're quite correct.
All right, so then that comparison you're making there, it still don't make sense. People that say things and then...
All right, no, it's not that it don't make sense, you know, it's just a little escape into our reality here in Trinidad, because if we're not real, we wouldn't understand that when some people do some things, it have a group of people, or based on who you support, we don't have no problem with it. So you see like how I highlighted that fact, and you highlighted the same fact was done elsewhere.
Right.
It have some people who have no problem with it.
And that
it's only one.
And that is the problem.
And I keep saying, and I keep trying to explain to us in this nation, only the 41 MPs win when we approach our politics like that. As heavy duty say, we're not voting on policies. But the challenge is, when you vote on policies, it might be against the PNM or against the UNC, the next party running up to grab the fame, right? So if you're talking something against the PNM, UNC will want to grab to lean on that. Or if you're talking against the UNC, PNM want to grab to lean on that. That is getting us nowhere in this country. And I keep saying, it's time that we wake up and understand, on what pitch could Kamala really be Dr. Olia based on track record? Not his own track record, you know, but hers. The fact that you're not amounting the amount of support that is required to deal with Dr. Olia and the PNM, Kamala. Why don't you simply step aside and make room so that somebody could bring what is required to challenge Dr. Rowley?
The problem there, caller, and I would say it again, is all you're watching Kamala as the problem. Kamala is not the problem. Kamala, even though you're watching Kamala as not the solution, Kamala is not the issue, right?
All right, stick up with TC.
We have a real dread issue where we country falling apart, but we studying Kamala. She's not
right.
Is Kamala on the front burner right now?
You're just sending my point straight home with what you said, right? Kamala may not be the issue, but she doesn't have what it takes to remove the issue that we are currently facing.
That is your personal opinion.
That is your opinion, caller. Why you say that? What did Kamala do? Go ahead.
It's not about, all right. Let me tell you why I'm saying that, heavy on TC, right?
Mm-hmm.
If Kamala have all these opportunities and elections to face Dr. Rowley for the 9 years that passed, right? You lost in 2015, but 2015 to now, what significant ground have you gained that you have the nation behind you that we really ready to come and remove Dr. Rowley? You understand what I'm saying?
That is a very unfair statement. Let me tell you why.
Okay,
right?
TC.
It's an unfair statement only because, right?
Mm-hmm.
Wasn't your life better? Yes. Wasn't your life better in 2010 to 2015?
Financially, I must say yes.
Oh God, I'm not asking
right?
you financially
he said,
alone.
He said yes. He said
I'm,
yes
not, I'm not asking you financially alone. I'm asking you overall.
Overall.
Let me forget financially. Wasn't your life a better standard of living?
No, TC, because I have improved on my own, not by no help of the government, you know, right? You see, the government have made me have to make certain downward adjustments. Okay. But my life and lifestyle in general, right, is not based on, they are not the ones improving my life, if you understand what I'm saying. I am who doing it, right? But what
is the lives of the other people in the country improve?
So is life in the country better?
Overall.
Of course not. If we have people at the top,
so how come Kamala is the problem?
So how come Kamala is the problem and she don't have the
what it takes to win an election?
Very good question. How come Kamala is the problem, right? Based on the fact that Dr. Rowley and them constantly asking us to adjust downwards, them right. still living the merry life, right?
Right?
How come in Trinidad and Tobago, Kamala is still the problem?
Because
let me tell you why. No, let me tell you why.
Yeah.
You see, like how you say that you have no issue with Fitzgerald, but if he's not getting the job done, then it's best we move him and find somebody else.
Right.
If Kamala take on Dr. Rowley, we need to move on and put somebody else
that
who could challenge the man.
You see, again, you're going back to that, but you cannot tell us why she cannot take on, because that is what they're putting,
that is what they're putting in our head.
All
right. See, that is not what they
are putting in our head. Yeah, let me hear you. Remove Kamala, put who?
Yeah.
To take on Dr.
No, that is something that the UNC needs to come up with.
No. If you know, and you're a political analyst,
yeah,
and you know that Kamala cannot win Dr. Rowley in the next election,
who
in the UNC will put...
You must know
who can put to fight the election, who?
Who would I choose from the UNC to go up
against? To go up against Rowley, who if he can beat Rowley?
I like that question.
Who I would choose? Who I would choose to go up against Dr. Rowley from the UNC?
Yeah.
Well, I is not no big fan of Rudal Munilal, but I think that I would put him. Instead of Kamala.
You know what I feel you try to do? You try to sing the UNC.
Chris,
you want to make sure there was election.
Tell me.
All that you're fighting for there is a non-entity, one.
Mm-hmm.
But two, you don't even have a solution to it.
Yeah.
You understand?
You see, because
all you're regurgitating there is what we have been
hearing.
That Kamala can't take. But what is the reason for it?
Yeah.
Nobody can
because she has been lost. Because she has been lost consistently.
And let me explain something. Hold on. Let me tell you something, Chris.
Yes.
In the last general election, you know they gained two seats, right?
Right, no problem.
Right.
They
so which
two
means
seats.
They did better than the election before.
Right. And in the local government election,
there was a tie.
Right.
Good.
No problem.
So they're making forward movements. All they need right now is to win two more seats.
Nice. Okay. Beautiful. No problem.
Right.
But here is my challenge. In this, as I say, we have to accept a portion of reality in our discussion, right?
Right.
So, yes, she making incremental, small incremental gains, right?
Yeah.
No problem. My issue is when we are saying to the nation that we under serious pressure and duress, and we facing all these challenges from the wicked and evil PNM government and Dr. Rowley. The work should not be so hard for Kamala to gain back what she had when she was in 2010, which was 29 seats.
Let me finish. It's not me wanting it to happen now, TC.
What I'm saying is, if we are facing all these challenges, right? Gas raising right through, people asking you to cut back on your macaroni pie, right to work, go back to coal pot, all these different foolishness we're hearing from the leading arm of the government, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then the work for the opposition ought not to be so difficult to remove them. Unless it's a big bunch of dotish people running around here in Trinidad, we really fully
done. See, that is in your opinion. All right. So I'm glad we're saying that, right? Do you know, right?
Understand what I'm saying, eh?
I understand what you're saying, but what you don't know, right? What you don't know, right?
Tell me.
This is what you don't know,
mm-hmm.
right? Is that the same party that how we under pressure, right?
Yeah.
They themselves have a machinery and a propaganda machinery that so and the resources to reprogram the whole country, right? To believe that the last 9 years when we went through all the pressure, all the coal pot, all the macaroni pie, all the waste gas and taxes and everything didn't even exist. And the whole focus is to get, don't let the UNC come in power. You know they're good at that, right? And that will make is what make it hard. And that is what make it hard for the UNC to win the election.
Heavy, I don't think, you see, like you, but I feel more than you, I am fed up of the blame Kamala,
Chris,
blame US.
Right, all right. You and I and a lot of other people, but there's there's over 200,000 people in Trinidad and Tobago love that. And guess what?
Well,
in the words of KFC, yes, you won the election. Listen, Chris. Yes, I love that.
Yeah.
And the words of KFC, yes, you won the election by ring. PNL will pick up them vagrants who sit like long under RBC Bank in Port of Spain and carry them to vote. I'm telling you.
All right, Chris.
I don't know this.
Chris. You're always good talking to you. Much respect.
Yeah.
Hi, good afternoon. Over 200,000 people in Trinidad.
Hello?
Hello?
You load on your radio in the background.
Yeah, I did.
Right, go ahead. Let me hear what you're saying.
Who am I speaking to?
You're speaking
Heavy?
To... Yeah, Heavy and Tissi. Yeah, you're on the show. You're live.
Oh. Yeah, this is Janine from Toronto. I really love you guys. You're doing a good job. And I just want to answer the guy that called earlier. When you asked him about what did he like about Kamala, he said finances. Isn't that what runs the world? Isn't that how you get out of poverty?
Yeah.
Isn't that how you get a good education?
Yep.
So I just want to let you know that, you know? Because he's so wrong. And even if you don't like Kamala, you guys got to get out of this situation, man. This thing is going to turn like Haiti. It's not a joke. It's very terrible what's going on in Trinidad, and it hurts me. Yeah. Oh, and TC Maz went from Samoa, eh? You want to say hello? You want to say hello? He's shy. He's from Old Road and Saddle Road.
Okay.
Old Road.
How are you?
Much love and respect to your husband as well.
Sawa, man.
All right. All right, take care.
All right.
Toronto.
Yeah.
Toronto, loud.
Well, but how we loud in Toronto?
I'm seeing calls coming in, but we have
17 seconds for the break.
For the break. So when we come back, we're going to take all your phone calls.
And we see some voice notes coming in too.
We see the voice notes coming. So stick and stay, don't go anywhere. We will be taking all your phone calls when we come back around. All right?
The season changes. Let's continue to show that ocean of unity for each other. Let's harmonize that sweet rhythmic sound that comes from deep within, that reflects togetherness, getting back to the issues that matter the most. One mission, one station, the Street 919 FM.
The views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
You've got bills to pay, and so do we. Let's go pay some bills on the Street 919 FM.
Yo, this is
is a Big Mike, not the mass man, the health man. And joining me
will be Little Mike as we discuss tips on taking you from zero health to optimum health using different protocols and techniques. Trinidad and Tobago, join us every Wednesday from 10:05 a.m. to 10:35 a.m. on the Street 91.9 FM for
Health Talk with Big Mike. It's not where it is, it's here it is. Boom!
Lent is here, and the castle is making fasting easy and tasty. Come enjoy any of our five delicious fish options. All made with a fresh catch, seasoned local style, and cooked to golden perfection. Try the fish meal. Two slices of fish with a side. The fish combo. Two slices of fish, one side, and a drink. Maybe the fish sandwich combo of one sandwich, a side, and a drink. Want more fish? Well, the Royal Fish Meal is for you. Enjoy a slice of fish, a fish sandwich with a side and a drink. Or maybe you just want our famous fish sandwich. The delicious Lenten specials are hot and waiting for you at your nearest Royal Castle.
Southern Games Organizing Committee presents Southern Games 2024, Skinner Park, San Fernando, in memory of the late Jim Kins Clark, former chairman of the Southern Games Organizing Committee. Saturday, 16th of March, athletic heat from 2:30, admission free. And Sunday, 17th of March, cycling and athletics from 3 p.m. Admission adults $60. Children under 14, $20. Tickets available at Athletes by the Park from 4th March and at the gates. For further information, you can call 368-5649 or 778-3274. With God, all things are possible.
Conscious talk, where we are at and where we are going. After a storm, there is a calm. Where there is darkness, light follows. Where there is evil, good overcometh. It's Conscious Talk with Steve Antoine. Every Thursday from 10:25 a.m. to 10:55 a.m. It's Conscious Talk.
Conscious Talk. Talk. Talk.
Join the winning team with Pastor Alkaline John every Tuesday at 11:05 a.m. to 12 noon and every Wednesday night from 7:05 p.m. to 8 p.m. live on the Street 919 FM as he talks about LaVive, the power of five fruits, one of the most powerful antioxidant supplements on the market today. The five superfruits in LaVive are mangosteen, acai, pomegranate, goji, and noni. These fruits have a positive and profound impact on human health performance and disease. Join him as he gives live testimonials of the LaVive healing powers. To get more information, you can contact Pastor Alkaline John at 516-286-7079 or you can visit his webpage at www.alkalinejohn.com. Remember, every Tuesday at 11:05 a.m. and Wednesday at 7:05 p.m. live on the Street 919 FM.
The views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
Share the line.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM on Facebook and Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa George on Instagram.
Share the line.
Iowa TV and Street TV on YouTube.
Share the line.
The Street 919 FM.
We are back, heavy, and the phone lines are going crazy, so I'm not going to waste any time.
Yes, I'll go back one time.
To the phone lines one time and allow the people to say their two cents.
Put it back up.
All right? Of course, we have some voice notes there as well. I'm going to be playing the voice notes as well, all right?
Yep.
Caller, good afternoon. Welcome.
Yeah, hello, brother KC. I was here, you know, you're asking somebody if their life was better from 2010. So then why the UMC get vote out of office? They've had 29 CP and they've had 12. People in Trinidad are real bad, and then they get rejected by
brother,
the
brother, you misunderstand the question, huh?
They get rejected by the poll in 2020.
I rejected them at the polls.
What's me?
Are you listening at all?
Yeah.
Right. I rejected them at the polls. I went and vote PNM.
Yeah, but what about 2020?
You're not listening?
Yeah, but what about 2020?
I went back and voted for them in 2020.
Yeah, but what about the local government election? When
you're not an answer. See what you want? Well, you want argument. And yeah, we don't argue
here.
You're not trying to block me up. You can't block me up. I just speak the truth. I vote them out, right? In the 2015 election.
You vote them for worse or better?
I vote them out believing that I'll get better.
And did you get better?
No.
So then what the hell are you talking about?
Well, he could speak that and I voted them out. So I know what you're talking about. I not devoted to party.
Is it better now?
Hello, good evening.
Yes, sir.
I not on you.
You don't even know who you're talking.
I don't have time with you. Hi, good evening. Welcome.
Hi, good evening, TC and Heavy. This is God. How you all going?
Yeah, we good. What's up?
Hi, good evening.
I'm good, man. I'm good. After coming to this, well, it's good to get you on the number one talk show in Trinidad and Tobago.
Thank you.
It's good to be able to converse with you guys. I have to come and defend my leader, Kamala Pusabi-Sessa. And, you know, a lot of people making a lot of statements. Our lives are no better now than under Kamala Pusabi-Sessa 2010-2015. And we normally, like the last time they raised the price of gas, she asks us to go out and protest, come out on the highway. When you go and you see the people who come out, are just UNC people. Mm. We need Trinidad and Tobago to come out and support this lady to make this change, to make this difference. Kamala Pusabi-Sessa is the leader of the UNC at this point in time. Presently, she will face the polls in 2025 with her candidates, and we will attain victory. We just need people in Trinidad and Tobago to come out and support us. Let's make this a safer place, a better place. The PNM has done nothing positive for Trinidad and Tobago. Nothing. And I mean, you guys ask people this question. Are your life better now than in 2010 to 2015? And it's not. Because everything is failing. We as young people must take back this country. The only person who could do it is Kamala Pusabi-Sessa. Give us the opportunity. Like I said before, yes, we made mistakes in the past. So has the PNM. Right?
Yeah.
Keith Rowley went to the parliament and lied about the email gate stuff. What came out of it? It's just lies. It's just lies. And they keep fueling that and fooling the supporters that they have. People need to open their eyes and realize, come on, we young people need to take back this country. And Kamala Pusabi-Sessa is the best choice with her candidates that she's going to present. It's better than what we have here now.
Thank you.
So thank you, brothers, for allowing me the opportunity to talk this evening. God bless you. Be James.
That same caller there that called just now, you're calling to Carol about who life was better. I sure your life was better in 2010 to 2015.
Just said he get a whole pension raise. He get the pension raise and that Kamala be calling to Carol.
I sure. Look, but you want to argue with me? Don't argue with me. I am not the problem. Your government is the problem.
Harry and TC. We talking about America politics and China politics is two different things. Them constitution based on a different kind of form. We first past the post. And that's why you see this movie land kind of attitude that we taking place at the platform. And there's we talking such a foolish talk and people that buy them thing. But the way in the States their politics is based on policies. It doesn't see how much agenda they have before they go up for election. Different policies they had a vote on there. Not here. Here is only race. And one set up a canal talk. That's what they're voting on. Have a good day for that.
Good afternoon, TC and Heavy again. I just want to highlight something. We need dry season now. Not even one tractor cleaning them rivers and things. We're waiting for the dry season. When people get flooded out and they're complaining, then the government looking to send tractors and things to clean up them rivers. Come on now, PNM. Or they do something better now, man. When Kamala was here, 2010 to 2015, every year, dry season, the cleaning rivers, you understand? And I know about it. I used to go and catch my little teeth and then when them bulldozer pushed down that water, it's real teeth and wabbing and coscorab and then jumping. No one even getting a fish.
Loving the house, TC. You know what I'm saying? You come like, you get a man or something to do, you know the answer for it, eh? You don't know how to do it, eh? But when he do it for you, you telling him the answer, we put it wrong, and you don't know how to do it.
Yeah, yeah.
Be careful how to move Dr. Rowley, Kamala, what them had to do with this? Kamala is a loser, what a great matter, what? It's we the losers, boy. We lose everything Kamala leave we with, boy. We is losers, you know. Not Kamala, you know. And himself, the Lord, the general election come in. You feel them lose?
No.
All they be all they so foolish, all they is, boy. What them could lose, brother, is we you're losing, right, brother. And we have a chance to get back everything we lose, plus more. We have a chance. You know, we could move the PNM, the right, clear-thinking people, by. All they live here for the last 8 years, or. Neither all they wasn't here for the 5 years before that. But it didn't have supposed to have people on the fence and on the side and all them kind of thing, by Kamala, but you understand. So wait, I don't tell you, no, all they looking to play the blame game, you know. There's a blame game all they can play here already, and it's not even an election. They say when Dr. Rowley stay in power, it's because of Kamala. And it's one vote she have. It's one vote she have. How she make Dr. Rowley stay there when we going through all the pressure? They ain't going through it, you know, for the 8 years, you know. Kamala and them still have it nice. And we calling them losers. It's we's losers. They ain't going through what we go through, you know. Hmm. And what we going on go through if we leave here, you know.
Hmm.
And you still saying she had to do something for you to vote against Dr. Rowley. Dr. Rowley do everything for you to vote against him, boy. What a head is, boy.
Wow.
Why we crisscross back to front, wrong side, upside down, big people, so, boy?
Telling me?
Well, they have to save the children, boy. All the senses together here now, boy. We come learn to do it. We going to vote out after we done know the mission is to vote out. The only thing to make that happen is to vote for the UNC, but we're talking about Kamala. She proved herself already. Proved herself for 5 years. We was happy spending money and purchasing power, working. We're talking about, like all it was in Trinidad and Tobago. Yeah. Loving the house. I voting for the UNC. My clothes. All the evil set of wicked, ungrateful people, boy.
God.
I'm on top really,
eh? Heavy, you talking about all them vagrants and them were lined down by the bank and them in town? But I joke. All them Spanish and them done their line up to vote for PNM already.
Okay.
Yeah. All them Spanish and them who come here under work permit, them done get promised citizenship for next election already. So how you feel going on?
Your partner, who does cost you, Heavy? You going on cost you?
Why is it that all they refuse to accept what Chris said? Kamala is the reason why the UNC cannot win. Because if people keep saying, this is the worst PNM, this is the worst PNM, and all of that, yet she cannot win a general election. And for your information, the UNC won one additional seat in the 2020 election, which was Moruga Tableland. Right, so get your facts right. Just as Oluk accuses the PNM of blaming Kamala for everything in the country, every loss that Kamala lost, every election, Oluk have to blame somebody. If it's not the EBC, it's the rain, it's something, but Oluk have to blame somebody. Oluk will not accept that the reason for UNC losses is Kamala Prasad Bisesa. God, didn't you say that if Kamala should go up against Dr. Rowley in 2025, that she will be slaughtered, that she ain't worth she salt? Didn't you say that, God? You're just as two-tongued as Gary and Philip.
You know what I like about him? We just play his voice now. We don't ridicule people here, you know. We just played a voice note, and I knew it was him, and I played his voice note. You can continue making a contribution. Once your contribution is respectable on this program here,
mm-hmm.
We want to hear from you. You understand? Once your contribution is respectable and you're talking sense, sometimes you ain't talking no sense, but still, we can take your contribution. It's not a problem.
Hello, TC and Heavy. Oh, they forget to tell the guy who was talking long, Chris or whoever his name is, that talking about how much our election Kamala lose, how much, and Rowley lost, he get decimated in Tobago. How much? 14-1? They don't remember that. They only know when Kamala lost anything, but they doesn't remember the PNM one. Have a good day. Tune in.
Yeah, man. Thanks so much. So we could continue to take the calls now. All right. The argument is very heated, but this is not about who is who. This here is about heading to the next general election, and was your life better then or now? simple.
Good afternoon, Christian Heavy. People fail to realize, people must remember what it is got UNC into power in 2010. The pressure that people was under, and by how many votes that UNC won the election. And within that 5 years, what Kamala did in 5 years, Dr. Rowley going into 9 years now, and he didn't do half of that. He didn't do half of that. And this woman raised pension twice, disability twice, public assistance twice. It's everything. You understand? In 5 years, by the time this man come in, get into power, this man call a recession. Boom. You understand? It's on your belly. People band their belly down to their back. You understand? And up to now, belly still banding, you know. Belly have not banned yet, you know. And they almost 10 years, you know, your belly still banned. And people fail to realize that. Kamala is the choice. It's not Kamala cause UNC to lose the election. Not Kamala at all. It's how many seats they had. UNC had more votes. They had to go by according to votes, how much votes you have. UNC winning that election all the time. It's how many seats you have. And we have to see that they get the amount of seats that they have to get to win. When you look on the board, it's yellow, right through, you know. People never was blind, son. Did you see these things? No, man. People, they're ready. According to what most of the callers say, Kamala have nothing to lose, you know. Kamala, bread, butter, ready, everything. She's fighting for us. Not for herself, you know. She's fighting for us. It's for we she's fighting. That's it. Thank you very much for taking my call.
Thank you, caller.
Yeah, I'm loving the house, said it right. Mm-hmm. Loving the house, said it right. You feel she bread butter. She losing next general election. She's just going to go to parliament as normal and sit in the opposition. And
collect your money.
You understand? And our life will continue to go downhill.
Correct.
Whether you like it or not, that is what will happen.
You see this talk we're talking about, Kamala, yeah? This is a non-identity talk. I find we song like the show USB every evening after. Right? Because to me, right, what I know for a fact, as a man in politics for years, here what I know for a fact. Anytime the UNC make the mistake and move Kamala now, they're going to lose the election for sure. You know why? Do the UNC need to change up the leadership and thing? Yes, but not now. The reason why Kamala have a strong support base right in the UNC. One, two. There's nobody viable enough, likable enough by the base to switch
right now.
Nobody. The base don't like nobody more than Kamala right now. Right. I'm talking about the base at this UNC.
Yeah.
You understand?
I understand.
The NC, not even Munila had a support. If you understand where I'm coming from. So moving her now is going to, they're not going to vote for the PNM, you know.
But they're
going to. They're just not going to vote.
Yeah.
You understand? Can't take that chance.
Yeah, sorry.
Yes, Mr. Owens.
What is happening here? We must understand.
Mr. West, say hello, long radio. We get feedback.
All right, I'll call back.
All right.
Radio loud, Mr. West.
Yeah, you listen to me loud. That political suicide to move Kamala right now. And they know that, the PNM know that. That is why they're trying to push for the shit to move. If you understand where I'm coming from?
Yeah, really,
they're trying to vilify the heart and say this and that and that and that, but Kamala can be the top three best prime ministers we ever had in the country. If you understand where I'm coming from, where policies and things to better the country, it performance and thing. Me don't know why they want to move the woman.
Well, good evening.
Yes, good evening, Mr. TC and Evie. The fact remains, we may be at a juncture now where the PNM is strategizing. They've been strategizing for quite some time now. It's multi-pronged. They're attacking the leader of the party. They want to create dissension in the party. And then they just call the election and everything and just run through because you have internecine warfare, tension between in the party itself.
Yes.
So you... So this is the opportunity. I hear you had a long conversation with that gentleman there. I don't normally, I deal with ideas. I deal with issues. And I'm saying that one has to be very careful. They are all about creating dissension in the party. They would come up with all kinds of propaganda, all kind of mischief about who want to take, who form in party, who have this, who won't be. That is the strategy. That is the playbook. That comes out of, if you go back, right back, that is how they operate. And they want to create, I'm saying, a certain measure of instability within the party, and then they just run through. That is the whole thing. And they come in all different forms, you know. They come in as people who care about, but if in fact you so care about Kamala, you should be happy that she's not, you know, measuring up. She's not the kind of person who could, in fact, compete against the Dr. Rowley, as it were, because it's easy for you to win. But it tells you about the reverse psychology. You must understand that.
Yep.
And that is what they're all about. And they take all kind of different angles they come from. They come from all different angles, and you have to be very careful. You have to be mindful about them. The fact remains is that you cannot change any leader at this point in time. You're going to lose the election.
Correct.
You cannot. You're going to create dissension in the party.
That's political suicide. Right?
And they are aware of that. And that is what, and they strategize. That is the whole strategy. They have their strategies in Ballyhale also, you know. They have their people listening to all these. One of those people confess that they have their people there listening to talk show hosts, and for different reasons. Reasons to some extent having to do with defamation and sedition and all that. There are reasons with respect to getting a sense, a feel as to what is going on the ground, thinking of the people, and therefore what is required. And they write their script. Most of them come with a script. If you listen to the talk show host during the program during the day, it's a script. They have a script that they go on various stations. You could go on all the PNM stations and you hear them spewing the propaganda. So this is the time for people to come together and consolidate and forget them and the nonsense. You have to focus. And the question, once Rowley remain as leader of that party, the PNM is not guaranteed victory in the next election. That's the fact. That is where it is. At this point in time, once he remain leader of that PNM party, they're not guaranteed success at the next election. But they turn it around to tell you it's Kamala. And if that is the case, well, is Kamala there? Because it's easy for you to be triumphant.
Yeah.
Thank you.
The same thing.
Thank you, Mr. West. Thank you.
Yeah. I want to know, if it's so easy,
mm-hmm.
It's a walk in the park if Kamala stay there. Why only bother about Kamala?
Yeah, why only bother about Kamala?
I'm just glad. I wouldn't even talk about she.
Exactly.
I just say, hey, let she
stay. We have it in the bag. Let she stay there.
Yeah, but only talking about her and making
if she's the problem, they're going to lose. Well, all right. Well, she's glad she did it to fish for them to lose.
Yeah. Yeah.
If she track record, is she losing?
That's sure.
Then what are forcing for?
Yeah, I don't understand it.
It's a reverse psychology thing.
Yeah.
The Freddy woman.
Yeah, for real. Call again, England.
Yes, Dr. Rowley, talking about the homeless people. Half of the homeless people, they are pensioners. They're getting disability. They're getting public assistance. What the homeless people want is a home. If he's smart, he would build places and rent it for the homeless, for the pensioners, the people getting disability. Yes. And the economy would go, because money would go out and come back in. You understand? But you don't have that. You have that foresight as Kamala. Kamala have that foresight, but you have more vision. You understand? Than Dr. Rowley. Dr. Rowley had to walk the ground and feel the ground, know what people on the ground want. Not to just stay in his office and talk about when they build this place for this shelter for the homeless people. They ain't gonna have no homeless people. They should not have no homeless people on the ground. And he's then attacking the human rights people already, technically. Because you know the human rights people fight for them. I'm not saying it is right for homeless people to defecate on the pavement and to sleep on the pavement. I'm not saying that is right. But you have to find the root cause of what causing homelessness.
You have to call, because a lot of people used to pay rent and they can't pay their rent right now. They get evicted from their apartment. Where they have to end up is on the streets. He know that. Mm. If you don't know that, are you letting him know that now? You understand? Majority of the homeless people, you have to find out the root cause of it. Not just building a shelter, and next thing you say, and that shelter might finish in 2026. Not 2025, but 2026 that might finish. You understand? So all that time homeless people say, only now we wake up and realize how much homeless people all over the place. Nah, man. You have to wake up and smell the coffee. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for your contribution. I was going to play this voice.
Good afternoon, Heavy. Good afternoon, TC. Good afternoon, Trinidad and Tobago. Heavy and TC, I always make this analogy what Mahatma Gandhi once said. If you're riding a tiger, you have to prepare to continue to ride that tiger, because the time you want to come off that tiger will try to kill you. The PNM has been riding since 2015 on lies, propaganda, half-truths, innuendos, and all the other things you could think about under the sun. This PNM, this Keith Christopher Rowley, do not care. They don't have a heart. They don't care for nobody, TC and Heavy, and Trinidad and Tobago. And all they're calling about Kamla. Well, I want to show me who again it have to lead Trinidad and Tobago. Who you want to ask, Gary? Who you want to ask, Philip? Who you want to ask? People of Trinidad and Tobago, I want all you to wake up. Let us all unite under one banner. Let us unite under the red, white, and black, and get rid of this wicked, evil, taxing, lying government. Thank you very much.
Good evening.
Good evening. Good evening, Brother Tisha and Heavy.
Hey, Mother, what's going on?
What? Dr. Rowley, you lie so much, this and you lie so much, you lie this and lie that. Them talking the truth. Them, everybody talking the truth about Dr. Rowley lying in this and that and the other. When they have something, say something good now for the country, they're very encouraging people and to vote for them. Them nothing, them people calling on this program. Some of them, they want people to vote for them, peer them people.
Mommy. You just call them during the day, so and tell them, oh gosh, you'll come off Kamala back a little bit now. You just call them?
Me have to tell them, come in, Kamala to be on everybody back.
Everybody, yeah.
She don't be on the African back. Mami, she don't be on Dr. Rowley back. Mami, you don't hear when she don't call the Oriya and all kind of
Mami,
thing.
Mami, I ask you a question. You know, yes. Answer the question. I never ask you who back Kamala does be on.
Yeah, well, wait, you're telling me.
Listen to me now.
Do you
call here during the day and tell them, oh gosh, holy, let go talk about Kamala, so?
Well, I don't have to call them and tell them, so, come up and Kamala back.
So why you coming here?
Them run the show.
So why you calling here to call, tell them, come up and Rowley back?
Well, everything they say, Rowley, everybody is Rowley lying. Show, yeah, that looks so bad.
Is we running the
looks
show?
Looks so bad, Rowley lying, Rowley this, Rowley that. Mami. And he running the country, the man running the country. Mami. Good. Mami. Good.
Mami. Mami. No,
you going?
Yeah, he's up, Mami. A little bit. Mami.
I don't want to say. Mami. Oh, you're like the first chef of Kamala here. You want to get shit back?
You ready?
She ain't
getting back, Kamala. That's
it. Oh, my pension only gave me. Mami.
You mad?
Oh, my pension only gave
me. You mad? You mad?
Get oh, back God. What? My baby, you get this,
you know? There's something wrong with you, yes? Get back who what? Heavy, come on.
You
come
be
good evening, Cola.
Good evening. They really say abuse is addictive. You hear mommy posting about Dr. Rowley running the country good?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. The other one say how Kamala can stand up for Dr. Rowley. To Dr. Rowley, I didn't know that was Kamala's job to stand up for Dr. Rowley. Them really feel there's a football match or whatever going on, you know. Yeah. They don't realize it's serious governance to bring the country back on speed. When I listen to these people, they really don't understand what democracy is about until they wake up one morning and see that all of us is in a position when we can't even open our mouth to say a word.
Thank you. Well said.
I tell you, boy.
Yeah, wow.
Mommy say, Dr. Ronnie running the country.
She real good.
Real good. I got
Yeah. Good afternoon, heavy ETC.
Yeah, man.
Yes. No. You have to ask yourself, how much elections Kamala lost? Every election going along the line, she lost. Right? So, we, you know, say, we don't want her to move. Right? She can stay right there. So, she will lose again. Right? Right? Right. Because is every election come straight down, she keep losing.
Right.
So that wouldn't give you or the supporters or the leadership or something at the party, whatever you call them, something to think about. Right? They have to come together and think about it.
No, they don't have to come together.
And right? Think because about if you keep losing all the time, so.
They don't have to come.
They expect to come and win this one, and then on top of that,
they don't have to come together and think about it. What you all have to do is mind all your business and make sure that all your happy that the day so all they could win.
Then
you now waste 2 minutes of your time calling to talk about that. You now waste 2 minutes of your time,
and then
right?
No, well, let me tell you.
Yeah,
but then again, the country getting a positive outlook, and it's not we who say that. We get a positive report from the IMF, and I ain't only talking about that. Kamala have a support. She have a support.
Don't move further. Wait. You enlighten us on what is the
positive report of the IMF?
From the IMF.
The IMF said that we are on a positive growth path.
Listen to what I'm saying. Right. The IMF said that?
The IMF said that.
Okay, who is the IMF?
The International Monetary Fund.
And what is their job?
There are some countries that are in trouble.
Right.
Right?
Okay.
And they give you a positive outlook of a growth path. Now, I ain't saying... Now, listen to what I say. Don't want to...
How we reach for the IMF to speak about our country if they only go in to look for countries
that need help?
We didn't say that. The IMF do their research. And they put out their report. Listen to me, Kola.
You don't understand what we're saying, right? The mere fact that the IMF had to come to get to do a review on us to give us a report, it means to say that we in dire need. We badly off.
No, you're trying to push it.
The IMF is only going to countries to help them move on.
You have foot in mouth. So why are they not talking about it?
Not making any sense. That's what we're telling you. That way you're saying they're not making no sense.
Lent is here, and the castle is making fasting easy and tasty. Come enjoy any of our 5 delicious fish options. All made with a fresh catch, seasoned local style, and cooked to golden perfection. Try the fish meal. 2 slices of fish with a side. the fish combo. Two slices of fish, one side, and a drink. Maybe the fish sandwich combo of one sandwich, a side, and a drink. Want more fish? Well, the Royal Fish Meal is for you. Enjoy a slice of fish, a fish sandwich, with a side and a drink. Or maybe you just want our famous fish sandwich. The delicious Lenten specials are hot and waiting for you at your nearest Royal Castle.
Here's a tasty meal tip from Royal Castle. If you like having something different for lunch or dinner today, then we have fantastic fish meals too. Get the fish combo of two succulent pieces of fish, one side, and a 16-ounce soft drink. Or the fish sandwich combo of a tender, tasty sandwich, one side, and a 16-ounce soft drink. The castle uses the freshest fish with its famous enticing local seasonings, all cooked to golden perfection. So try our fantastic fish meals today. Royal Castle, our culture, our taste.
This meal tip was sponsored by Royal Castle. Our culture, our taste.
Loving yours, heavy and TC again. Trinidad and Tobago too. You were saying like it's a traditional thing with the PNM. Because since all in Manning time, before Kamala come, Manning telling people tighten the belt. You know. Tighten the belt. You know from the moment he lost and Kamala come in power, Kamala come and start to spread she wings. This man saying don't have money and punishing poor people all the time. Look how this woman come and spread she wings all in all them constituency, whatever him didn't even vote for she. The whole East West corridor. And Manning saying all the time, tighten your belt is a traditional thing with them. Look around, we come now. Look around, we come now. You know, they're talking about Kamala is a loser. Every election Kamala lose is double hardship for we, double pressure for we. All ain't seen is that happening. From since Rowley come in power, when he nearly lost our election going day. Boy, you find two seats, that was he get more angry, more hardship he hit with it again. Now it coming is worse, he don't care. It's no money for the poor. Plain the man said that all, yeah, boy. No money for the poor. Why is only poor people following the man? Like I said, well, in some kind of deep coma or some kind of trance or something, but no money for the poor. Well, let's save all yourself and save all your children, yeah, boy. Well, I'm always still thinking about Kamala to move. Well, let's see everything that happened. For me to vote out the PNM. Everything. What Kamala to do with it? That was saying that ain't making no sense. I mean, studying all the youths and them waiting out here patiently for election. He know that. We waiting for election, all them youths and them waiting. That's why I'm telling you to vote you out from there. And you know what? To hold you accountable too, because we have substantial evidence. That's what the opposition leader have on them. Substantial evidence to put them away. It's not no lies like when you come with your allegation, email gate and all kind of thing and fool the people. No, Dr. Rowley is not that. And it's not she alone have evidence. You know. We, the citizens, have evidence, but you're a wicked soul. Just what I'm telling you, and you go pay, your ends will be horrible. I say so. Love in your house. State and balance.
Thank you, love in your house. For educational purposes, I want to tell people what the IMF stands for. Not the syllable IMF, eh? I don't know it's the International Monetary Fund, but their policy. The IMF come like a bank that is lending country money. But in order to get money from the IMF, they just give you a whole set of stipulations and rules that you have to implement in your country before you can get any money borrowed, right? And some of those implementations may involve very hard, stringent measures for your citizens to undergo, okay? I don't have the list I was looking for it, but I will Google it. But we don't have time. We have a little bit of time, and I want to take as much calls and as much voices as possible. So I want to let the caller who called just now, who want me to believe that a good review from the IMF is a good review. A good review from the IMF means to say that they
the government that the IMF want to borrow money from is putting the stringent measures in place on the people in order to get the money borrowed. That's all that it means. It means to say that they are doing exactly what the IMF want them to do. Tax, tax, tax. Take, take, take. Make sure we're suffering before they collect money. IMF like to see a country people dragging before they can lend you any money. Otherwise, you are not qualified for loan from us because your country is on stable ground and have money. So we getting a good review doesn't mean that it's good. We governing the country good. Nonsense. Don't see? It doesn't mean that we are governing the country good when we get a good review from the IMF. It means to say that we are doing exactly what they want us to do. Thank you very much. Go ahead and please.
Caller, good evening.
Hi,
good evening.
I like how you're talking this evening. With a song like a dancey teacher. You're a dancey teacher. You don't know your head from your tail.
Spell dancey teacher. You spell dancey teacher. You can spell dancey teacher, spell it.
Wait for time.
Dancey, spell it, spell it. Let me hear you spell it, dancey teacher, spell it. Can you spell dancey teacher? We're calling to tell people that dancey teacher.
Caller, good evening.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, TC. Good afternoon, Evie.
Good afternoon.
Evie, I think you should be saying, see them kind of person? They might have to go and meet them for this country to go better, you know. Yeah, I listened to Mommy just now that she said the UN, Kamala was on black people back. And she called the Prime Minister Oreo. Them doesn't vote on policies and opportunities for their grandchildren. Nope. Them vote on that race, boy.
Nope.
But where Kamala, if Kamala is the fault, them understand I talk about Kamala, well, leave Kamala there. If we know they go have an election.
Quietly.
Correct?
Yeah. Quietly.
Correct?
If I about this evil, that's PNN government. After 9 years, you come up and ball them, you go and build this and do that. Them all trying to fool somebody, right? You come out to the election, tell them to do that in the East West Corridor, right? You know, the PNN just keep the last move for last. People will forget where they were go through and go and hold back the PNN. And you get into a human being, the likes of separation, and people like separation and wickedness. Okay. And you're like, Trump safe now. Love and respect.
Blessings.
Blessings.
Forgetful Jones.
Back in 1984, when NAR went in there and seized the country of the money, they went to the IMF because we literally had no money. And the IMF tell me, all they want money from us, all they now come out of oil boom, all the people living happy like papi. Uh-huh. All they have to cut back, and that is why they have to cut all the back pay, all the 10%, all the cut people's salary, send home people, all kind of thing. It's because the IMF tell them that to do that.
Paula, good evening.
Yeah, good afternoon to CN Heavy. Yeah, well, right now we really are really governing here with IMF policies. All the IMF policies is in place. We just ain't got no money yet.
Correct.
We ain't got no money from the IMF yet. But I want to say something this afternoon. What these supporters are scared of, you see that political forensic audit into the expenditure of this administration, you see that $64 million they paid to do our audit and petrol, we want back that money. That money has to return. I listened to a senator with a program here. Now, I always say this, the people of Trinidad and Tobago just pay the opposition and we just pay the ruling party, so we have to listen to both of them. This election coming here is an audit into politics here, and we're going to break record in this country here by making sure these people get held accountable for what they do in this country. You know, the kind of money I hear man talking about, this money lost, this one fall short. You have to be crazy. That's not your personal money, like taxpayers' money, and you're trying to raise more taxes on the people. You have to be politically mad. And people trying to call and try to defend that. I want them to know this afternoon. Right now, I realize the people from Venezuela, good afternoon to you all. you always have good people amongst you all, and it have some terror that all they are allowed to be around us here and not identifying them. How come Venezuelan Robin Maxwell in the East West Corridor? What is that? What is that? Look, we have a lady who just called to auction radio, and she's a kind of mouthpiece for the Venezuelan. Stop pushing Trinidadian in a corner. We go react on all and we all even like it. We have good Venezuelan working here, but you see those who want to come and dictate a criminal activity, and you Trinidadian who like to play all going along these people with the drug thing and ending up on the bad end of the stick, all cut out that because the innocent will pay for the guilty. Remember, we was warned by a prime minister, do not elect this prime minister here because he have a close allies with Venezuela. That was one of the main reasons why Patrick Manning never wanted him to lead. That whole house brutes are gone.
Thanks
so much for your contribution.
You don't have it easy. You see the nonsense and fellas talking. So much of football, Trinidad lost, and I'm still walking Trinidad. I don't know what's wrong with him.
TC, what the fella meant that in birth on a positive group. You understand? He's a, you know, a positive group, but he growing by about an inch. Not the country. Is he growing? That's a foolish talk. Heavy. Yeah, it's after six. You had them vampire and them calling you to attack you, boy. Oh, gosh.
Good afternoon. Earlier on this evening, three Venezuelan rob a bus and passenger. 8th Avenue.
8th Avenue? Yeah, that's what the guy was speaking about.
Where's that?
Three Venezuelan rob a maxi this evening. I stopped out on 8th Avenue. Yeah.
Okay.
Good afternoon. Earlier on this evening, three Venezuelan rob a bus and passenger. 8th Avenue.
Have TCPDP. Boy, let me China know something. If all of move Kamala, Israel problems. Well, I'm not willing an election, and it's that PNM want. And to that, Don Sibato just calling the. You understand? Family, granny, you sound like a dry fat coming from a wet dog. Why are you going to make a bake for your grandchildren and then we're going to wash off or something? You're calling the talk. Go and wash off, granny. TC, have a blessed evening.
Good afternoon, TC and every. TC, remember I was telling you about that building in Boney, how the children and them used to go and do little kicks and then. Just last week, I see they come and they cut down the sign with Kamala and them, they pop, and they pop a sign for the PNM and them saying Youth and National Services. I said, whoa. I said, coming up for election time, they go pop down in the campaign thing, showing that them build a school and thing. That what PNM just do. They just cut down the signs on them with Kamala and them pop, and pop the new sign, and paint up the building and thing, and put that. So everybody go think PNM builder. PNM never build that. Kamala build that and put it in Boney where all them PNM supporters is.
Great show, guys. Great show. 10 out of 10. Live strong. Live strong. KFC, Kingsley, all we supporters and them. Continue doing what they're doing. TC and Heavy, have a good evening and reach home safer.
Good afternoon, TC. Good afternoon, and we last had a ticket and a robot. And robot was really kind of human being, Dr. Rollins. Dr. Rollins is not a normal human being, Dr. Rollins is an obia man. You see, we know Patrick Manning. When you feel the country has so much evil and crime, so much literature and dying, remember the election move. Don't let the PNN come over and kiss all the babies. The selling soul to win the election. Fire upon this evil, wicked Atlas PNN government.
Wonder if all are aware that the mere motley that all love to praise and worship that Barbados is in the IMF program for the longest while. It's catching the tail. You can't disrespect all your allowing all your callers to call and say, yeah, what that man say about the woman, and all in pull him up. But ask somebody call Kamala junk KFC. You have to study why your brother was killed for all the injustice all he did to people in Port of Spain.
Yeah, and look what you're going to do. Yeah. Yeah. You now talk about the suspect. And look at Eddie voice, what you said.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, TC. Good afternoon, Heavy. This is the kind of illiterate, ignorant people we have in this country. What has Indian people done but good for this country? And all they could remember is Kamala this and Kamala that. Please, people, leave that woman alone for me, please. And try and go and look at all your history. Okay? And stop calling about calling TC and Heavy. I'm talking about done. Half all your policy, all your name, all you can't read and write.
All right, all right.
Have a good evening.
All right, Alice. Oh, God. Right, to the country, boy. Right.
I want to tell that last call about you call me and Motley and Barbados. Barbados progressing, and Mia Motley didn't lie when she first went out for election. She didn't lie to the people. She told them she was going to the IMF. She told them she didn't lie. But Barbados is progressing.
Yep.
TC, that man who talking about Barbados, he's a dunce. You're a dunce, boy. Barbados under IMF. But Barbados right now is one of the most successful Caribbean islands. Look at the things. Go on Google. Go on Google.
Yes, Google.
Barbados and see them success in the last 5 years. We even had 3% of them success. Why it doesn't come off of the radio and go in a grave and sit down, boy?
Yeah. The Barbados went to the IMF over the COVID because Barbados' economy is based on
heavy,
tourism.
Heavy, you still going on explain that. Heavy, he know.
He don't know that.
He know that. You see, they don't educate themselves until I put a certain point in it.
Mm-hmm.
That is political education. You see where the right way mommy does get her education?
From Coco?
Right. The next woman who call and say you dance? Right there, she does get her own. Right there, that man does get her own too. Right? Nobody not fighting them because here what has hurt them. You see when you come.
Yeah.
And the truth really busts out. Right? That does kill them heavy. It does hurt them. Because they can't deal with facing all that they done facing already. Right?
Mm-hmm.
All the stress that they going to deal with. All the you get how much raise a pension. Under camera. You never get one under the said prime minister.
Nope.
Sitting in for 2 terms. He never see you.
Nope.
And you nothing.
Nothing.
He never see you in his eyesight and you nothing.
Nothing.
You're not in the horizon to get anything.
Nope.
Right? But you get in 5 years under the Indian woman.
Mm-hmm.
Right? You get more than once.
Yeah.
Right? And if
you get 2 back pay.
Okay. And if right? If, are they showing here, this prime minister to come now and say, well, do you see what she had given already?
Mm-hmm.
She really did give all too much. We can't afford that. They will find a reason why he should really take it back.
Take it
out
back.
Of them,
out of them money, yeah, yeah.
From them.
Yeah.
That's how dumb and stupid
it is. Yeah.
They will call and say, yes, he have a right because you remember Kamala did give away all and only had money for 3 days, so he tried to get back money now, after 9 years later.
Yeah.
So he really had to take back some because we want to make sure that it has some money. 9 years later, I think.
They will find an excuse for that?
I am telling you.
Yeah.
I am telling you, Evie, they will.
They will.
And it's taking it back from them.
Yeah.
Them will not say, you have to be a madman. Don't worry, I'll survive.
Yeah, I go survive.
I don't know if I find the cat survivor, eh? Because what they have now, the barely make it ends with the cat survivor or not.
Exactly, Evie.
But it will seem no problem if the band take it. I'll take 500 from everybody for pension here. Yeah. They will say, okay.
And he go as far to say, well, remember, all they're going to dead anyway just now. Then he gonna, them going to jump and say, yes, you know, he right.
Yeah.
We really going on there just now. Mm-hmm. So it's better you really take back some.
They will say that, you see. They will say that. They'll be perfectly okay with that.
In the little time that I am sitting here,
mm-hmm.
right, in this political arena, I've learned some stuff that is shocking. I never believed that people will love a party or a man
mm-hmm.
more than themselves.
Themselves and the children.
And the children. I'm going to say it again, eh? Mm-hmm. I never believe it have people out here
mm-hmm.
with love, a party,
mm-hmm.
or a man or a woman more than loving themselves. I never knew that.
Did they know that?
If somebody had told me that,
I cannot tell her that.
Madness.
I cannot tell her that.
But now, sitting here and hearing,
but you know, even worse than that. Guess what? Worse than that.
What?
Then don't. The, not only that, the fact that they love the party and the man more than the self and the children, you know. They're willing to attack and defend and go out of the way, take the money and credit on the phone to call, to chastise people who talking on their behalf. Yeah.
They don't want to talk on their own behalf.
No, they're not talking on their own behalf, but the people who talking on their behalf, who talking for them to get better men, who talking for to get change, them is the enemy. They're going out, they hate you.
Yeah. What you doing there?
Yeah.
Why are you talking? You should hush and let we suffer.
And let we suffer. Leave we, let we suffer. They want to take we money, leave them.
Yeah.
They want to give we tax. Yes, yes, give we tax.
Raise the gas.
Raise the gas.
That's
not your problem. Yeah. You're done, take your man come.
Grow, she could go up how high. What happened to you? Why you got to talk about that? If they want to kill somebody right in front of school, they want to kill some children, whatever it is.
They don't care. They find you shouldn't tell them about that.
Wow. I have two short voices.
There we go.
I would like to see you take back mommy and them pension and them from them. Mommy and them deserve no pension.
Good night, fellas. They say empty vessel does make the most noise. Just tell them people why them hungry. Why they again on so they're hungry.
Them not hungry. I don't believe they're hungry. I really honestly don't believe they're hungry. Because a hungry man is what, heavy?
A hungry man?
With them happy, heavy. Them happy taking licks.
Them happy taking licks, yeah. Them just glad that he beaten me, yeah. I hear they say that, I didn't know.
Heavy, them people and them say they don't care, boy.
Let me tell you.
Them people and them say they rather suffer than vote for Indian. That what they say?
Yeah, they rather suffer under the PNM than prosper.
Any program like this. This is why in slavery days
mm-hmm.
the white man or the slave owner, whoever he may be,
mm-hmm.
used to put our own people over our own people.
To beat us and do us all the wickedness.
Because they look at it and say, to get them to understand, we'll put one of their own
mm-hmm.
and they will take the licks from their own.
Yeah.
They will take all the abuse
from their own.
They will take everything that comes their way from their own.
Yeah.
Other than
somebody else. Some are different race or different. That's all it is.
That is just what it is. I can't play loving
those boys. Two minutes.
You just send some good boys over some long ones.
Yeah.
We have about 30 seconds before we wrap up, right?
Yeah.
I continuously watching numbers heavy,
mm-hmm.
right? I continuously watching numbers, and I want to say congratulations to the people that makes our program, right?
Mm-hmm.
One of the biggest programs on this radio station, right? We are right there. When I tell it, and certain days we are over, right? what okay. is deemed to be the top program here.
Right? Oh, okay.
Most of the times we are second, and I would like us to keep ourselves steaming right now.
Right.
As the season changes, let's continue to show that.
Keep it safe, share the life. We go on. Love and respect. We are.
Mixed sound that comes from deep within, that reflects togetherness. Getting back to the issues that matter the most. One mission, one station. The Street 919 FM.
The views expressed are not necessarily the views of the management of the Street 919 FM.
You've got bills to pay, and so do we. Let's go pay some bills on the Street 919 FM.
Tune in to the Street 919 FM every second, third, and fourth Thursday at 8 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. Welcoming you to Reset with Dr. Livett, your weekly guide to holistic health and wellness. As we dive deep into the worlds of holistic health, from ancient herbal remedies to cutting-edge holistic practices, we'll explore it all. Join Dr. Livett with over 11 years of experience as a holistic health practitioner, healer, and master herbalist as he shares invaluable insights to help you reset your mind, body, and spirit. Reset with Dr. Livett every second, third, and fourth Thursday at 8 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. Only on the Street 919 FM.
The Spiritual Baptist Faith celebrates the 73rd anniversary of the repeal of the Shouters Prohibition Ordinance of 1917. Get ready. On Friday, the 22nd of March, 2024, there's a traditional open-air wayside service at Isaac Junction, Coover. Time will be 7 p.m. Dress code, national colors. Come and hear some dynamic men and women of God expound the gospel of Jesus Christ. On Monday, 25th of March, 2024, come and participate.